right, it is Free Talk Live. You know, there's every once in a while, it's really obvious to us the story that we need to be starting off with, and I think that this is it's pretty clear that this county clerk, this is an elected position, this woman Kim Davis.
And when Mark says us, he doesn't mean Free Talk Live. He means the three hosts, particularly sitting in this room, who actually care about current events.
I mean Free Talk Live. Sometimes it's obvious, but this one's obvious. There's no question which one we start the show off with. This lady has refused to sign off on the marriage certificates. She's the clerk of the court. She isn't some functionary. She is an elected position. If you know anything about elected positions, you get that this clerk person's a relatively important position in the county. Now it doesn't matter. It depends on the county as to how big and how important she is. But every county I know of has one.
And based on the population and pay grade in Kentucky, because I had looked this stuff up a couple days ago, she makes somewhere in the neighborhood of $75,000 to $80,000 a year.
Yep. So she's refused, now that the Supreme Court said everybody's got to get the marriage license or whatever, then she said, nope, I'm a Christian and I don't have to do it. Now, it would be as simple as firing somebody if she was an employee.
Yes.
She is not an employee. She's elected. So
she's a slug.
Well, the judge has said that she had to do it, and
numerous judges, yep. By the way, because she initially filed a complaint with the Federal Circuit Court asking for permission to not issue marriage licenses. I think it's the Sixth Circuit is where Kentucky is. That circuit said, no, you have to do it, but we'll give you a waiver until all of the court hearings are done, basically. And she then went to the Supreme Court, petitioned the U.S. Supreme Court for permission to not
ignore
be required she wanted permission to not be required to do what they said she had to do. And the U.S. Supreme Court rejected her request for a hearing. That happened on, I believe, Monday. On Tuesday, she was still refusing to issue marriage licenses.
She answers to a higher authority.
The Kentucky Attorney General's office apparently said on Tuesday that they were investigating whether or not to charge her with official misconduct. The federal courts said you have to appear in federal court on Thursday, and today is Thursday, and this is where we stand.
So she shows up?
She shows up. And is found in contempt of court for refusing to issue marriage licenses. Now, it's not just same-sex couples that she's refusing to issue marriage licenses to. She has refused to issue any marriage license at all because she doesn't want to be perceived as discriminating or something along those lines.
She figures she has a stronger stance by saying, it's the purview of my position to give out marriage licenses, and I choose not to do that at all. If I'm going to have to give it out to the gay folks, I'm not giving out to anybody because Jesus Christ, my Lord and Savior, says no.
Her argument would have been a lot more solid had she not issued any marriage license at all from the day she was initially elected clerk of courts.
Sure, she stopped once she got this ruling was in place. It's pretty obvious what the lady's about here.
Right.
And
so, Mark,
it's also amusing, by the way, this lady who's been married four times, including some incidences of like her children being being impregnated by another guy.
That was before I found Jesus.
It's true. It's before she found Jesus. There's no doubt about it.
I didn't become a hypocrite until after I found the Lord.
Well, I'm just pointing
she
it out.
Still
that we all
she still accepts divorce filings from people. That apparently is not a violation of what she believes her religion says.
Yeah. Well, I mean, I think it's important to point out is that nobody stopped her from making mistakes. Right?
Right.
Like, and this isn't her role. Her role is to do She's an employee of us, is the idea. She's elected, and she's supposed to do these things. I don't think the woman, I don't like the idea of her being in jail. I really don't. But
really?
I don't, no.
Oh, I think it's fantastic.
Well, that's because you just hate Christians.
No, I hate ignorant, hypocritical idiots. She is clearly a moron. There is no, I mean, like,
if you put every stupid
least,
person in
you know
prison,
what?
You'd have half the population.
You know what?
By definition,
I could respect
half of the population is below average.
I could respect a Christian who had at least logically consistent principles. There is nothing logically, like Daryl just pointed out. Also, you're kind of a Christian, right? You kind of wrote a book about Jesus, didn't you?
Yes.
Yeah. So
he's a believer.
I don't use the term Christian, but it fits, and I'm not going to argue the point
right
now.
The first argument out of Daryl's mouth was, she's approving divorces. Why is she doing that?
In mixed fabrics and, you know.
People that eat shellfish.
She's eating shellfish.
People that, I'm sure she doesn't ask people, what is growing in your garden? Do you have more than one type of plant growing in your field? Because there's a prohibition about growing multiple plants in the same field. So, Mark, you're a Quaker, correct?
Yep.
So, Nick Sarwak, who's the chair of the Libertarian National Committee, posted something on his Facebook a couple days ago. He said, if a Quaker clerk refused to issue concealed carry weapons permits due to his religious beliefs, do you believe he should be fired or should he resign? Or should he be allowed to do that because of his religious beliefs?
Yeah, I'm a Quaker, and I would say that first off, I'm not sure that clerks have that power
in some places.
Okay, let's say that they do somewhere, and that a Quaker is in charge there. They're an elected clerk of court. I've got to say that Quaker needs to step down. I don't want to see them in jail.
My response was, most of the Quakers I know would refuse to take a government job in the first place because of their religious beliefs.
And that's what should have happened with this woman. So the fact that she decided to take the job and then be an ignoramus,
she may have had
on
the
clock,
longer.
You know, on the clock, yeah, she should be in jail because she decided to take, you know, steal from taxpayers and then not do her job.
Well,
do not pass go, do not collect $200, go straight to jail.
Well, I got to say, having seen so many pictures of her online, what's really clear to me is that she's been so obvious with her gay bashing that she can't even find a good stylist.
Oh, yeah.
That's true. Let's go to Andy in Texas. Andy, you're on Free Talk Live.
Hey, how are you guys doing?
Good. How about you, sir?
I'm doing all right. You know, this whole thing, I really don't care if you marry your car, your dog, your horse, your fish, whatever.
Because those things are equivalent to marrying a human being.
Well, but I mean, a man on a man or a woman on a woman, we all know what the obvious thing is. You know, a man and a woman, they can create life. A man and a man, well, they might be able to give life to some child who doesn't have a family or whatnot. And that's fine and dandy. I don't really care how people react to this or not. And this
I'm sorry, fine and dandy. Was that a pun? Was that intended?
Oh, perhaps.
That's the name of the gay couple, Fine and Dandy.
Is that really? Oh, well, hell, I didn't know that.
No, go right ahead.
But no, you know, having said that, I think we're making way too much out of this, and it's just another distraction from all the real big things that are going on in this world and stuff. And every time something like this happens, it's another distraction. It's just something that comes up in the news, and we all have to talk about it, listen to it, and hear all these different sides, including my side, you know. It just seems to me a bit ridiculous considering all the other things that are huge in this world.
There are lots
right
of
now.
Important things. There's no doubt about
sure.
it. One of the things about talk radio is it tends to be immediate, right? Like you end up talking about the issues of the day. Talk radio relies on its live aspect, which means there's nothing more immediate than that. So, what do you think's more important? What do you want to talk about?
Well, I think what's more important is the fact that we have a bunch of idiots running our country, and we all know they're idiots, and the fact is that a lot of people aren't pointing that out. I mean, your show points it out. You guys talk about a bunch of idiots that are running our country.
I imagine we're going to get even a worse load this election season.
Yeah.
Oh, without a doubt. I mean, without a doubt. How could you even question whether you're going to get a bunch more BS out of this thing?
Thanks for the call, Andy.
Every time I watch the candidates running, I just circus music plays in my head. Like,
that's what Trump is to me. He's a bear on a unicycle. You know, the flavor of the week.
That's insulting to bears that ride unicycles.
855-450-3733. Free Talk Live.
Every once in a while, you get information that's worth changing your life for. This is one such time. You can save up to and beyond 25% on all purchases at Amazon. You probably heard of Bitcoin and just not thought much about it. You certainly know that you can get competitive pricing at Amazon, but now you can get a 25% discount on nearly everything you need to live. I've just given you a huge raise, and all you have to do is claim it. You go to purse.freetalklive.com and open an account. Do this right now, don't wait. Then you fund the account with Bitcoin. You can buy them through expresscoin.com with a check or money order. There are other ways to get Bitcoin, but that's fast, safe, and easy. This information is worth you changing the way you do things. Go to purse.freetalklive.com right now and get signed up and cash in on the huge raise I'm offering you. 25% off of everything on Amazon through purse.freetalklive.com. It's purse.freetalklive.com.
That's the sound your brain makes when you realize you're buying something and forgot the coupon. Online or in a store, knowing that you're missing a deal is the worst. You need the app from RetailMeNot right now. Get thousands of coupons from 50,000 stores like Kohl's, Domino's, Best Buy, and more with crazy deals like 60% off, free shipping, and free gifts with purchase. You can get a text invite to download the RetailMeNot app 100% free right now for Apple or Android. Just text the code UPDATE to 42767. Then just show your phone at checkout to save. It literally couldn't be easier. It's 2015. Keep your coupons in your phone. Stop what you're doing and text UPDATE to 42767. Listeners will get a text with a link to download it 100% free. Never forget another coupon again. Text the code UPDATE to 42767 right now. That's UPDATE to 42767. Message and data rates may apply. For terms and privacy, visit RetailMeNot.com.
Okay, open your mouth and say, ah.
Ah.
When your child has a sore throat, you need to know when to get help. The doctor-recommended Say-Ah Sore Throat Exam is your solution. The scientifically designed oral retractor offers a clear view of the throat, relaxing the tongue and minimizing gag reflex. Compare with a medical-grade chart, website, and app. Then you'll know just what to tell your doctor. A wellness plan in your hands in minutes. Go to sayahnow.com. Sayahnow.com, the new mainstay for every family's first aid kit.
Don't complain about your cable bill going up and up and up. Do something about it. Grab a pencil and jot down this special number. 1-855-905-MY-TV. The more cable TV rates go up, the better digital satellite TV looks. Say goodbye to the cable guy. And get more of your favorite channels in 100% digital quality for less money. Call 1-855-905-MY-TV. Sign up for packages starting as low as $19.99, and there's no equipment to buy. You get free HD TV upgrade, a free DVR upgrade, and free professional installation. You control what you watch, when you watch it. Record your favorite shows. Pause and rewind live TV. Even skip the commercials. Watch local channels too. At just $19.99, what are you waiting for? Pull out your major credit or debit card. Call 1-855-905-MYTV. 1-855-905-MYTV. Say goodbye to the cable guy. Cut costs and get more. 1-855-905-MYTV. 1-855-905-MYTV.
We the people grow cotton, weave fabric, engrave ink, embed strips and fibers to protect from counterfeit, then carting to a private bank, having it lent back at interest, forcing taxes to service debt. This capitalism, or was Jefferson correct when stating a central bank issuing the public currency is a greater menace to the liberties of the people than a standing army? Ted Anderson, I'm placing a free silver dollar in a book that explains our monetary system. Call for your copy, 800-686-2237. It's time to understand the system. Call 800-686-2237. That's 800-686-2237.
Now more Free Talk Live. Call in toll-free at 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-FREE.
Free Talk Live. The number is 855-450-3733. Again, 855-450-FREE, or you can call us on Skype. The username there is lrn.fm. You're going to have to send a contact request, but once you do, you can then call us straight away. It should take me about 10 minutes to approve the contact request, so it's not that big of a deal. The username is lrn.fm, and the number is 855-450-FREE. And we were talking about this gal, Kim Davis, who is...
I want to say something real quick about perspective.
Okay.
So, you know, one thing I heard Ian saying on a recent show is he was talking about, you know, this was right after the stock market took a giant dive. Ian was talking about, I don't pay attention to that stuff. no, I don't, you know, this is, I think it was Friday. He's like, I don't pay attention to that because it doesn't affect my day-to-day life and who cares, you know, kind of talking about the stock market. And I, you know, it was Chris, the Friday night host, was arguing with him about, you know, maybe this does affect your life and talking about how the market can affect basically everything.
Oh, yeah.
And Ian's like, you know, but there's nothing you can really do about it. So what's the point of paying attention to this stuff every day? Day to day, it's not going to change. There might be bigger things. But along that lines, in terms of perspective, you know, with the people, the government, the people running the government, stuff like that, if you are if you're gay and you don't have equal rights, a matter of perspective, this is a big issue. This is not something that's just like, it's a distraction. It's not a distraction if you are being treated like a second-class citizen and being treated like you're lower than everyone else, or that you're human garbage. That you don't see this as like a minor thing.
Well, I've heard some people say that everything that's not focusing on the Federal Reserve and some global conspiracy to something Bilderberg right. is a distraction. Right. So the whole
if it's not
point,
about the Illuminati, it's not for me.
Right. So like, distraction is relative, if you will.
Right.
You know, like there are times when I love being distracted. I love sitting down and watching a football game or watching pro wrestling because it's fun, it's entertaining, and it distracts me from all of the horrible things that are going on in the world.
You know, when it comes to football, I really love the feats of athleticism, but I cannot stand to see those guys get hit by those other guys. I see the way their spines are mashed yeah. around, and I can only imagine. It's like being in three car wrecks.
I'm looking forward to
in 2 hours. Do you want to get rid of the really, really horrible hits that happen in football? Take away the padding. Take away the face mask.
I'm looking forward.
Have you ever
watched
rugby?
Well, and dude, flag football instead of tackle. What's the point of tackling somebody when you can pull the flag
right,
off?
Right, but no, have you ever watched rugby? Rugby is just as violent, if you will, as far as the hitting and contact of football, but there's not the injuries because the people aren't doing this launch themselves as a projectile towards somebody, knowing I'm not going to get hurt. I've got all this padding. Ha, ha, ha.
It's actually interesting that you bring that up about taking away the helmets. There's a show. Have you guys ever heard of the books Freakonomics?
Sure.
Yes.
So they actually
It's hard to live, you know, be any way informed and not heard of Freakonomics.
Well, they, Levitt and, their names don't matter, but they do a podcast. And they do, you know, a radio show or whatnot. And recently this was the subject of discussion was basically football injuries. Because the doctor who is basically talking about the brain injuries.
It's all about concussions right now.
Yeah. Right. It's all about concussions and the brain injuries from repeated head, you know, basically repeated head trauma. And this is, you know, there's a movie going to be coming out about this doctor soon with Will Smith, I believe, is starring in this. So
I believe that's called Concussion.
Concussion, yes. So it looks like a fantastic movie. I can't wait to see it.
Will Smith in it.
I'm looking forward to...
How have I not heard about this movie?
It's really just started
like,
to be
I've
advertised.
Got more concussions than all of the other Free Talk Live hosts combined, not heard about this movie.
Maybe you have, and you just forgot. Let's go to Tony calling in from Arizona. Tony, you're on Free Talk Live.
Hey,
what's
I'm,
on your
I'm
mind?
Just not on this...
Tony?
Gay marriage, I mean, there's nothing wrong with that, but I don't understand them saying, well, the same-sex marriage, you know, I got an American Bulldog here, he's a male, I'm a male, why can't I marry him? It'd be the same thing.
He can't consent.
Know? I don't understand it.
He can't consent. The Bulldog can't consent. He can't say...
I do the same, I sleep with the dog every night, I walk him to do, I do the same thing as gay couples do.
As far as I'm concerned,
I can't reproduce with him. They can't reproduce.
Really? Do you have conversations with your dog where
he talks
to you about philosophy and his views on life? Your dog talks to you about his views on life.
He tells you.
He comes home and he says, "How's your day at work, honey?"
Well, Tony talks to him, and the bulldog licks his private parts. I mean, that's how it goes. That's how dogs are. Hey, look, there's
don't like anything that you put.
Does your dog
want to
adopt children with you? Have you guys had the discussion about whether or not you want to get kids?
He go for that. You go for that. But I got the same relationship with my dog as gay people got.
Well, the problem is your dog can't sign a contract, right? He cannot agree to the terms.
The problem is my dog can't pay taxes. That's the whole problem.
Okay. Well, I'm sure that they would tax your dog if they could.
Well, put your dog to work. What's he so lazy for?
If you if he got famous, right. If he got famous, you know, and like you made money off of him being in like commercials, they tax him then.
The gay thing is just moving too quick, and they're trying to control. I worked down in Key West. I was a bartender down there, and then when they would have a big
did you ever
gay
see a gay person
bash,
in Key West?
A big party.
Did you ever see a gay person?
99%. About 99%. And every time they had a big event where the tips were going to be good, I was cut, and they bring in a gay bartender. That's the rest of the
story. Maybe you should have considered like some really tight shorts or something.
I'm going to go to Kentucky and marry my dog.
Excellent. Thanks for the call. 855-450-FREE.
I mean, people that do that conflation of humans getting married and getting married to an animal, it's just sick. I mean, it really is just, there's a mental sickness there.
Well, I don't know.
For somebody who does that.
I think that a person should be able to marry another being that can consent. At this point, we have not established if, say, a dolphin or a chimpanzee could consent. So at this point, I'm just of the, and I said person or persons. Because
yeah, but
I believe,
Mark, there are cases where right now where it becomes contentious of whether or not somebody who has severe mental disabilities should be able to
marry.
They
do that, absolutely. And I think it can be very difficult. That we had a story here that we did on the air maybe less than a year ago of a young man who's got Down syndrome and wants to compete in MMA box fighting.
Down syndrome doesn't mean that they're an idiot, though.
I'm not claiming he's an idiot. I'm claiming that he is a person with Down syndrome, and the organization wouldn't let him compete because he wanted to, you know, he wanted to be a fighter. And this is what, I mean, the dude was ripped.
Right.
He clearly had Downs. You could look at his face and say, this is a person with Down syndrome. However, he was built for this, and he was ready to fight, and he wanted to fight like
these
other
guys
could.
And they got that extra chromosome strength.
He's got that extra chromosome strength. Whatever. I mean, it's cool. I think it's a fine line when you have a situation with somebody who's got disabilities, but I think you have to err on the side of human freedom. 855-450-3733. You think dogs have the same freedom as humans? 855-450-FREE. Free Talk Live.
Hey, Berkey Guy here. Are you still drinking unfiltered tap water? Does your water contain chlorine or fluoride? Will you have drinkable water in an emergency? The Berkey Guy is here to help you remove these and other potential contaminants from your water, thus helping you drink clean, purified water. We offer Berkey water purification systems at the lowest available prices online. Don't go another moment without Berkey system. Over the last 10 years, we've helped thousands drink clean, purified water. Join them by visiting goberkey.com or call me, the Berkey Guy, at 877-886-3653. That's 877-886-3653.
By now you know that wireless technology like cell phones do in fact pose dangers to the health and privacy of everyone. Blockit Pocket's wide range of products are unmatched in providing the protection you deserve. No scare tactics, just common sense. BlockitPocket.com offers quality American-made options to alleviate and eliminate these invisible dangers. Learn more at BlockitPocket.com or call 888-315-9618. BlockitPocket.com, enhancing health and privacy.
Sciatica, lower back pain, hip pain, poor posture. If you suffer from any of these problems, get ready to relax. Introducing an amazing product that's been in the market for over 25 years, the Sacro Wedgie. It was invented by a football coach using a common sense osteopath technique. He created this device to help his athletes by isolating and supporting the sacrum, which is the keystone of our anatomy. This wedge-shaped bone is in the center of our hips, where a lot of pain starts. Simply relax 20 minutes daily on the amazingly simple Sacro Wedgie and let gravity do the work, helping muscles rebalance and start releasing nerves. Sit in the sacral wedgie at the computer or while traveling to help correct posture to finally help relieve those stubborn aches and pains for only $33.95. It's made in the USA, so click the family-owned website at sacrowedgie.com, spelled S-A-C-R-O-W-E-D-G-Y.com, or call 1-800-737-9295. That's 1-800-737-9295. Relax your back pain away with the Sacro Wedgie.
Paid non-attorney spokesperson, Adam Pulaski of the Pulaski Law Firm with principal office in Houston, Texas, is the attorney responsible for the content of this ad. This ad is not legal advice, and the choice of a lawyer should not be based solely upon advertisement. Services may not be available in all states.
Attention Xarelto users. If you or a loved one took Xarelto and suffered a serious bleeding event, you may be entitled to financial compensation. Xarelto is a popular prescription blood thinner used to prevent blood clots and protect patients from strokes. These serious bleeding events have led to numerous cases of hospitalization and even death. Phone lines are open 24/7. Call 800-261-0937. That's 800-261-0937.
Hi, my name is DeRay, suffering from migraines, having Botox injections in my head and neck to alleviate pain, costing $1,500 out of my pocket. I discovered Dr. Ortman and Gentle Touch Chiropractic Adjustment called NUCA. I'm migraine-free since my first adjustment. Thanks for giving me my life back, Dr. Ortman. I wish they prescribed you instead of Botox.
Thanks, DeRay. Putting the bones back in place is only half of the solution. We design a nutritional supplement program the body can handle, actually absorb, providing nutrients targeting the problem area. Between NUCA and nutrition, we will have you on the road to a faster and more permanent recovery. Look us up on the web at drwortman.com or call 952-303-9124. Let us help you feel better faster. Wellspring Spinal Care at 952-303-9124. Again, that's 952-303-9124. Or on the web at drortman.com.
You are an individual with your own thoughts, decisions, and actions. So why should you be penalized for not enrolling in the subpar health insurance mandated by the government? Be truly independent. Visit libertyoncall.org. LibertyOnCall.org is a bold, innovative alternative allowing you to take back control and make your own decisions about your health care. Mention this ad when you call to learn more. 800-714-6993. That's 800-714-6993. LibertyOnCall.org. Call today.
This is Free Talk Live. Call in toll free. 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-FREE.
Live 855-450-3733. It's 855-453. We've been all over the board tonight talking about this clerk of the courts, Kim Davis,
who's
now in warm in the inside of a jail cell in Kentucky over refusing to let the gay folks get married. Also, we've talked about this this MMA fighter who's got Down syndrome. His name's Jared Holeve or something like that. I'm not sure how to pronounce his name, but he's got Down syndrome and he wants to fight. And I do believe he recently has been able to. So anyway, if you want to reach people with the ideas of liberty, do it from the back of your car with libertystickers.com. You can reach thousands of people with a bumper sticker. You know that people love to read them. You found yourself scooting up in traffic trying to read somebody's bumper sticker in front of you. Well, you can check out the vast selection of witty, poignant, pithy, and downright bombastic liberty-oriented messages at libertystickers.com. It's libertystickers.com. By the way, if you need to make stickers for your club, your church, your business, whatever, Liberty Stickers can help you with that too. libertystickers.com. So, Daryl, you wanted to talk about Jared. You particularly brought it up, and I've got a little bit of more information on it if we need it.
Yeah, so you were saying that if people want to fight, they should be allowed to.
Right. He's an MMA fighter. Yep. That's a mixed martial arts.
Right. And there was.
And the guy's tough.
I'm not saying that he's not.
Yep.
I've never met the guy. I've only seen the one picture that you showed me just a moment ago. He looks like somebody that could fight. But you said that the promoter or the guy running the fighting
organization.
Had some kind of objection to it, and I can sort of sympathize with, you know, like this guy might have some kind of other health problems. There might be some kind of liability to me as the promoter. So therefore, I'm going to err on the side of my pocketbook and say no.
Yeah, I get where you're coming from on that. That's but this basically ran one of these a petition campaign, and I signed it too, because I think that he should be able to fight, because there's no particularly good reason as a Downs person that he shouldn't. I mean, you know, MMA, not that great for your health.
Right.
I mean, there's plenty of injuries that go on the televised MMA. If you want something that's better for your health, there's all kinds of sports out there for like that.
Table tennis is a lot better for your health. Although I did get one of my concussions playing table tennis.
Yeah, I wouldn't doubt it.
How did that occur? I want to just stop down. I need to know.
Okay, so we were playing this weird, like, around the world table tennis thing to where we started with like seven people, and one
was
person would
hit. Was this beer pong?
No.
Okay, keep going.
No, I was in high school, and it was at the church rec center. So, you know, like, you would hit it, and then you would just keep circling around the table. And when it got down to three people, like, there was one time somehow I wound up hitting the ball to myself, and I had to run, and I dove to hit the thing, and I dove into one of the pool tables.
Let's talk. Go back to Garrett here. So, I can see how a promoter, people should be able to have the rules they want to have on their, you know, whatever their organizations are. Now, this organization's bigger than one guy who's was disallowing Garrett from competing, and it was just people being sort of overly cautious.
But the UFC is the largest MMA organization that there is. There is one guy that makes the decisions of who gets to fight in UFC. That man is Dana White. Okay. He decides who fights in his organization.
All right.
So whatever organization this guy was going to, it could be one guy that's making the decision.
Yeah, I don't know. He's not trying to take on the UFC fighters here. But whatever. It's an organization that whatever it's the decisions made by one person or made by a bunch of them. It's a situation where he got a bunch of signatures and people, you know, supported him. And I think that, you know, it's fine. That's a great way to do it. And I was happy to support him because I believe I understand what it's like to have that drive.
Right.
Want to fight like that.
I certainly believe that, you know, he should be able to fight whomever he wants to in a consensual manner. If that's in Bellator MMA, if that's in UFC, if it's in the WEC, which is the World Extreme Cage Fighting, as long as the promoter and whoever he's fighting is okay with it, but he should not be able to, like, go to a court and order some organization to allow him to fight in that organization.
What if that organization is the Florida Department of Business and Professional Regulation, which includes the Florida State Boxing Commission?
The Florida State Boxing Commission is not a boxing promoter. They license people to...
I'm not claiming that it's a... I didn't claim it was a boxing promoter. That was sort of the thing that you... All I'm said is that he was being disallowed from competing. And I didn't know who it was that, you know, you're going from my memory of a story that we read 9 months ago, and it turns out it's probably been over a year. And I now see, looking at the story, and I didn't know what point you were going to make on this, that the organization is the Florida State Boxing Commission was informed that the amateur sanctioning organization
was hosting. Okay, then take them to court.
Yeah.
Well, it's a government agency preventing this guy from doing whatever. Take him to court.
Right, a government agency purports to represent everyone, and that includes MMA fighters with Down syndrome.
Yes.
And that's why the guy should be able to fight. So there you go. And now, as I understand the story, I just recently got an email from him, and he sent out to the people who signed his petition thanking everybody that he's going to be able to fight. And I'm on his Facebook page right now. This is the kid's life. He's excited about the people he works out with. He's excited about his gym. He's got videos here of him doing clean and jerks, and you know, I mean, this is important stuff to him. And I know what it's like.
I'm sorry, doing what?
Clean and jerks.
It's where you lift the thing up to about your waist. You then squat down, pop it up to your shoulders, and then lift it up over your head.
Okay. It's Olympic. You've probably seen some very big men doing it.
Yes.
And basically, you take a large barbell, you lift it up as quickly as you can to... even with your collarbone. So you pick it up from the ground and flip up underneath it and get it up to your collarbone. And then you attempt after that to sort of shove it up in the air and hold it there for a period of like a second or two. And then you drop it to the ground. They just drop them. It's amazing.
If you've
to see.
Ever watched the World's Strongest Man competitions, yes. They don't use barbells. They use like tree stumps
yeah.
with and tractor trailer tires on the end.
Yeah, the clean and jerk is not a motion that is good for your body, and I don't recommend this for people working out, but it is sort of an accepted measure of strength, and
yes.
It's like the bench press. The bench press isn't a great motion for your body to do either. The incline bench with dumbbells is a much better one for sort of...
Mark, can you do a clean and jerk with an 800-pound Atlas stone?
No. I can't do anything with 800. I could roll it along with my foot.
You would be lucky to be able to roll it with your foot. You could probably look at it. You could sit on it.
If it's round, I can roll it.
It's going to take a lot of motion to get it to start rolling.
Right. I've rolled cars. What are you talking about? I mean, come on. I can roll a 3,000-pound car if it's in neutral. Sure, I can roll it. That's why we invented wheels.
Right.
Because you can move a lot more weight with them than you can.
But the difference is, with a car, you've got a much broader surface of which to exert your force. With the, what was the name of
Atlas
that
stone?
Yeah, the Atlas stone. It's completely round and smooth. And like you put your hands on it and your hands just roll. So like you don't really get the chance to exert your full force on it.
We're on a libertarian radio show. Atlas stone. Like Atlas Shrugged.
Yeah, like Tony Atlas, the former pro wrestler.
No, like Atlas
Just 7 days,
shrugged.
I'll make you a man. That's Charles Atlas. Anyway, I'm delighted about Garrett being able to fight, and all the best to him. So there you go. The telephone number is 855-450-3733. You can call in and talk about this Kim Davis gal who's now warming the inside of a Kentucky jail for her refusal to let the gay folks get married, contrary to the Supreme Court ruling. 855-450-3733. Or you can give your opinion as to whether or not Garrett should be able to fight. 855-450-FREE.
For P150, P150GA, P150OK, P150TN, C250A, C250E, C250Q. Not available in all states.
What's the scariest thing about going to the dentist? Opening your mouth or opening your wallet? Because just a simple cleaning can cost $100, and things like root canals can cost you hundreds more. If you don't have dental insurance to help, call Physicians Mutual Insurance Company, 1-800-809-5580. This isn't a discount plan or preventive-only coverage. This is real dental insurance that helps pay for checkups right away, so you can call today and get your teeth cleaned tomorrow. Plus, it helps cover the more expensive procedures you might need down the road. Fillings, crowns, bridges, even costly dentures. There's no deductible and no annual maximum. Your acceptance is guaranteed for one of these insurance policies, even if you're retired. There are no networks, so you can choose any dentist you'd like. Call in the next 10 minutes and we'll rush you a free information kit with all the details. 1-800-809-5580. That's 1-800-809-5580. 1-800-809-5580.
No way. Is that a real bullet necklace?
No, it's a 9mm bullet necklace with matching earrings, you'll notice.
Those are awesome. Where'd you get them?
Dave found them at PatriotNecklace.com.
Wow.
They have a variety of calibers and necklaces and earrings and keychains.
PatriotNecklace.com?
PatriotNecklace.com.
Your choice of caliber bullet includes a rugged American-made stainless steel dog tag chain. A percentage of every sale goes to military and service-related charities. And get a discount by entering GCN at checkout. Show your patriotism and support our troops with a bullet necklace from PatriotNecklace.com.
Turn on the news and you'll hear stories of natural disasters, political unrest, and financial crisis. In times of uncertainty, how will you take care of your family's most basic needs? Food Insurance, America's most trusted provider of freeze-dried emergency food, has solutions that fit your family's needs and budget. Our meals are delicious, nutritious, and come with a guaranteed 25-year shelf life. For a limited time, we are sending a free freeze-dried meal to all listeners of this program. Go to foodinsurance.com and request your free meal today. That's foodinsurance.com.
My name's Clyde, age 59, and I reside in Florence, South Carolina. The doctors diagnosed me as having clogged arteries. Felt like I was carrying heavy concrete blocks around my feet and legs. I started taking Heart and Body Extract as directed. It is less than 3 weeks, and I'm like a young man again. It's unbelievable that an herbal formula can work so fast and so powerfully.
Learn the secrets of an effective, natural, 100% organic nutritional supplement for a healthy heart and circulation at hbextract.com.
On the average, Americans work between 45 to 50 years, hoping to build up enough wealth to retire and live out their golden years. Unfortunately, with taxation, the rising cost of food, energy, housing, and medical, many retirees are forced to live below the poverty line. Is this a flaw of free enterprise, or is our monetary unit we call the Federal Reserve Note forcing us into perpetual debt, ensuring inflation and higher taxes? These questions and more can be answered by reading G. Edward Griffin's book, The Creature from Jekyll Island. Congressman Ron Paul states, it's what every American needs to know about central bank power. A gripping adventure into the secret world of international banking cartel. Hi, this is Ted Anderson. I will give a silver dollar from the early 1900s to anyone who purchases this book. Call 1-800-686-2237 and order a copy today. It's critical that the public be made aware of the system. Call and order your copy today at 1-800-686-2237. That's 1-800-686-2237.
Silver has always been nature's very own antibiotic, and only one system allows you to produce an endless supply of nano-sized silver solutions right from the convenience of your home. Silver Lungs. With the addition of our unique lung delivery system, respiratory infections are targeted directly, where traditional oral administration simply cannot reach. This pioneering method also preserves the original particle sizes and delivers your silver solution directly into the bloodstream. See the Silver Lungs generator and lung delivery system at silverlungs.com. That's silverlungs.com.
You're listening to Free Talk Live. Call in toll free at 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-FREE.
Free Talk Live, 855-450-3733. It's 855-450-FREE here on this live edition of Free Talk Live with Mark,
Daryl,
and Johnson.
855-450-3733. So this gal, Kim Davis, warming the inside of a Kentucky jail cell.
Yes.
Because, well.
Contempt of court.
Contempt of court, yeah. She's in the pokey.
Yes. And last I heard, the Attorney General for Kentucky is investigating whether or not to charge her with official misconduct. That would then allow her to be removed from office if she is convicted of official misconduct, would also see her see the inside of a jail cell for up to 1 year.
Well, I certainly don't wish that upon her.
Right.
She
needs to just
step down. If she cannot do the job, and the job is to hand out marriage licenses, she needs to step down.
Part of the job.
But she's refusing to step down, so...
Right. So that's why I think she should be convicted of official misconduct and then removed from office. I don't think that taxpayers should have to pay even more money to feed, clothe, and house this woman.
Yeah.
but it's not just her. Apparently, there are six others that might be warming the inside of a jail cell. The judge, Judge Bunning, told all six of Davis's deputy clerks that they must issue marriage licenses, or else they will face fines and possible jail time.
How are they taking that?
The lawyer argued that this is the lawyers from a religious freedom group called the Liberty Council argued that the deputy clerks can only issue licenses under Davis's authority. The judge overruled his objection. Five of six deputy clerks testified to the judge that they would comply with the judge's order to issue same-sex marriage licenses. The plaintiffs, however, raised the question of whether the license would be legal without the county clerk's signature. The judge would not rule one way or the other. Some were emotional about the decision. One deputy clerk, Melissa Thompson, told the judge that she doesn't really want to, but she will comply. She wept and said, "I'm a preacher's daughter, and this is the hardest thing I've ever had to do." The one out of six that said, "No, I will not do what you told me to, judge," is none other than Kim Davis's son, who is a deputy clerk, Nathan.
All right, I can just hear the banjo music coming out of this one. All right.
Attorneys for the four couples that are suing Davis proposed allowing her out of custody if she would agree to not interfere with her deputies issuing marriage licenses. The judge agreed to the proposal and ordered Davis to be returned to the courtroom. Davis did not return to the courtroom, and her attorney spoke on her behalf, saying that Davis would not make any representation that would allow for marriage licenses to be issued, thus not accepting the compromise that would have led to her release.
Now, we know that, I mean, yes, this is a government official, and it's her job to give out marriage licenses. She refuses to do her job, so she should leave her position. I would say that if you really want a marriage license in the state of Kentucky, you can drive one county over and get one.
That's like what she said, and her lawyer said in the response to these four couples, and they said, we shouldn't have to.
I agree that they shouldn't have to, but the difficulty is, like, this is an issue to some extent of sort of making people do what you want them to do. Like, there's a dominance aspect to this. And as long as we're clear on that, then I think it's okay. Like, this is a dominance exercise that people are in here, and don't expect me to get all excited about it. Goody, you made the redneck lady do what you wanted her to do. Congratulations.
I think the redneck lady should be fired. She should be forcibly removed from the office by the attorney general.
But if these people wanted a marriage license, they could have gotten it a week ago by simply driving one county over.
I don't know. My thought is that, yeah, you made the redneck lady do what she's getting paid $78,000 a year of taxpayer money to do. It's her job. If you're unwilling to do your job, you should leave that job, no matter what that job is.
Especially if it's a government job and you're refusing to comply with government orders by government judges.
All right, let's go to Zach calling in. I don't know where Zach is. He's calling in on Skype. Zach, you're on Free Talk Live.
Hey, Zach in Minnesota.
Okay, hey, Zach.
Hey, guys. Yeah, I've actually been surprised. It seems like it took Free Talk Live a couple days to get on this topic. I thought Derek would be on the show that night.
Derek J is not that motivated now. The former co-host Derek J is not. He's just not that motivated by gay marriage. He says that gay people should just go ahead and get married without the government.
Well, that makes sense. But anyway, actually, Marco, I was kind of surprised to hear you say just drive one county over. I mean.
I'm only pointing out that if you want a marriage, this is not a group of people that want a marriage license. This is a group of people who are trying to make a point. And I think it's fine if they're making a point. I just want to be clear that we're talking about a group of people that's trying to make a point.
Okay, so right. I'll let Zach make his point before I make mine. Go ahead, Zach.
Okay. I think it was Johnson, if I'm not mistaken. Said that she's getting paid to do this job. I can't go to work tomorrow and say, hey, boss, I'm only going to do some of the stuff you pay me to do because I don't agree with the other stuff. No, you quit your job then. Especially for the reasons, like the first time I saw the video, if you guys have seen it, where somebody was taking a cell phone video of this whole thing in her office. Mm-hmm. And it was the first time I had heard anything about it, so I wasn't ready for her to say under God's authority. And I almost lost my S word when I when I heard her say that. And I'm a baptized Christian. I believe in most of the Bible. I don't take it literally. I try to look at a bigger picture because it has been translated over and over over millennia. But I kind of, you know, try to take a bird's eye view of it and you know, take what I can from it.
Yep.
And I have not seen a single verse anywhere that condemns homosexuality. I have seen plenty that supports slavery, but I have not seen anything that condemns homosexuality.
Well, here's the thing. When I hear any religious person say something about God, right, and say something about like God's will or this is, you know, what God wants, or I always translate this into my, because that's everyone's view of God, right? And they always say, you can't judge God and you can't judge God's morals, but everyone does because God is good. And why is God good? Because you think God's good. It's a circular logic. Everything about most religions is circular logic. And so what that means is that anytime somebody says, like if she says it's under God's authority. What she's saying is under my authority, because that's what she judges, because she thinks that she's following God's will. And that it's what she understands to be God's will. And that's always the way it is with every religious person.
Yeah, I think a lot of times with this, it's their own bigotry that they're reverse engineering some sort of argument to fit.
Don't you think this has a lot to do with the preachers? I mean, if the preacher man that she's going to, the church she's going to, said that it was a good idea for gay folks to be getting married, then it's likely that some people that disagreed with him would leave the church, and other people would just say, well, I like him so much, he must be right. And so I don't know that it's her opinion. It's
I believe those people are influential for sure.
Yeah.
Well. Absolutely. And I think the only remedy for this, I mean, putting her in jail, I was really hoping that would not happen, because now she's just a martyr for the right.
She wants to make a point.
Yeah. She's being put in jail for being Christian. I've seen tweets from Huckabee and even Rand Paul, who I'm not a huge fan of, but he's kind of the least smelly pile of excrement in this whole arena. And even he came out and said she's being attacked for being Christian. And I just, oh man, you people are supposed to be smarter than this. Like, you're trying to run for the highest office in the country. They don't have a basic understanding of the Constitution or even what this is about.
So what ruling should the judge have made, to your mind, in this circumstance? Because basically, it's a fine or jail seems to be the normal thing to do. And I really can't think of anything clever.
She's also facing fines in addition to jail.
Yeah, but she'll get her fines paid by whatever organization's backing.
Exactly. What'll happen is, just like that pizza joint, I think it was Indiana, who came out against, it was even the same topic, and they had almost $1 million donated in a week.
Well, the thing with the pizza joint was that was basically a fabricated story by some news outlet where they went around and basically asked every business owner questions until one of the business owners said something that they could make a soundbite out of. They printed the soundbite as, business owner says he won't serve pizza to gay people, and that's never what the guy even said.
Right.
Zach, appreciate the call. 855-450-3733. Your opinion on Kim Davis is welcome here on this live edition of Free Talk Live. 855-450-FREE, Free Talk Live.
It's fall flooring season with incredible deals on the hottest styles right now at Lumber Liquidators Fall Flooring Kickoff Sale. Choose from over 400 great floors with over 20 laminate styles like American-made mahogany for just 49 cents a square foot, more than 30 bamboo floors like carbonized bamboo for only $1.59, and over 150 hardwood floors like pre-finished gunstock oak for only 99 cents with a dollar off Bella with 20% off Dream Home laminates, plus great floors, woodlike tile, vinyl, and more with 24-month special financing. The Fall Flooring Kickoff Sale is going on now. Visit LumberLiquidators.com to find a store near you.
Before girls' night out, my eczema flared up. Ugh, I felt like canceling. But then I tried Cortisone 10 Eczema Relief. It's specially formulated for eczema and has 1% hydrocortisone, the strongest non-prescription itch medicine for fast, lasting itch relief. It quickly stopped the itch and soothed my red, dry, flaky skin. With Cortisone 10 Eczema Relief, I was ready for girls' night out, and it was the best one ever.
Cortisone 10 Eczema Relief. Feel the heal. Use as directed.
Extend your life with Extendovite.
Why do over 50% of North Americans suffer from some form of chronic ailment? Could it be due to a toxic overload? It's time to take back your life. Get the lead out, as well as the cadmium, mercury, and calcium. Extendovite is a garlic cayenne supplement with five other herbs that acts like a natural Drano, cleaning out the stored toxins, restoring your energy and youthfulness that we've lost. If you would like to live your life free of sickness, pain, or fear, then Extendivite is for you. Available in either capsules or liquid, you too can see why Extendivite is the number one heart drop available. To order, call 1-877-928-8822. That's 1-877-928-8822, or visit our website at heartdrop.com.
Extend your life with Extendovite.
You're listening to GCN, the world leader in independent talk radio.
Breaking news this hour from townhall.com. I'm Keith Peters. Rowan County Kentucky Clerk Kim Davis is in jail this evening for refusing to issue marriage licenses to homosexual couples. Davis says it goes against her Christian faith. One of Davis's attorneys, Matt Staver, says it's incredible that something like this could happen in a country founded on freedom of religion and freedom of conscience.
Kim Davis is being incarcerated for her conscience. Why? Because she wants a simple request: remove her name from the marriage licenses so that it doesn't come under the authority of Kim Davis. She cannot issue a marriage license that's contrary to God's definition of marriage with her name and title as an authority on that license.
U.S. District Judge David Bunning ordered Davis to jail today. Five of her six deputies say they will comply with the judge's order, though they are reluctant to do so. A staffer who worked on Hillary Clinton's private email server while she was Secretary of State is expected to plead the fifth rather than testify before Congress. Details from correspondent Linda Kenyon.
Lawyers for Brian Pagliano say he will assert his constitutional right under the Fifth Amendment not to answer questions when he appears before the House Select Committee on Benghazi. Pagliano is scheduled to appear before the committee next Thursday. The committee is looking into the Benghazi attack in Libya, but it is also investigating Hillary Clinton's use of a private email server. The investigation has prompted the ranking Democrat on the committee to release a statement saying the investigation is politically motivated and designed to derail Hillary Clinton's run for the White House. Linda Kenyon, Capitol Hill.
The white man accused of killing nine black churchgoers in Charleston, South Carolina, will face a death penalty trial. Prosecutor Scarlett Wilson says she'll seek capital punishment even though some of the victims' relatives oppose it. Dylan Roof is also charged under U.S. hate crime laws. Federal prosecutors haven't decided if they will also seek the death penalty. More on these stories at townhall.com.
They say every healthy relationship should have a balance of predictability and spontaneity. In fact, it is that assurance of security that makes the spontaneous possible. Your relationship with your car should be a little like that too. With our industry-leading unlimited mileage warranty, your certified pre-owned Mercedes-Benz instills a sense of confidence. You drive away knowing that you can keep driving for up to 3 years and never have to worry about the miles. Add to that our complimentary prepaid maintenance on select models, and your certified pre-owned Mercedes-Benz becomes the ultimate carefree escape vehicle. Only during the Mercedes-Benz Certified Pre-Owned Sales event, going on now through September 30th, can you receive your first 2 months payments on us on select models plus 3 months of Sirius XM satellite radio. So hurry in today. It might just be the most predictable spur-of-the-moment decision you've ever made.
See your authorized Mercedes-Benz dealer for complete details and limitations on certified pre-owned warranties.
Vice President Joe Biden was down in Florida continuing his exploration of a possible 2016 Democratic presidential candidacy in the wake of the failing poll numbers of Hillary Clinton. He was also extolling the Obama administration's Iranian nuclear deal.
If we can take the nuclear bomb off the table, it's better dealing with those bad guys than if we're dealing with the bad guys and the nuclear bombs on the table.
Barry Weiland says the vice president was impressive in the meeting, but didn't sway him in favor of the nuclear deal.
I saw a side of Vice President Biden I'd never seen before. He was forceful. He was cogent. He was factual. I almost was convinced.
Meanwhile, three more Democratic senators support the deal: Senators Cory Booker, Mark Warner, and Heidi Heitkamp. News and analysis at townhall.com. I'm Keith Peters. Almost 12,000 students are asking the federal government to forgive their college loan debt, asserting their school either closed or lied to them about job prospects.
The figure represents an unprecedented spike in what's called a borrower's defense claim following the collapse of Corinthian College's for-profit college chain. It's become a symbol of a higher education system that sometimes promises more than it delivers. Under higher education law, students who believe they are victims of fraud can apply to have their loans discharged. In addition, officials say more than 7,800 Corinthian students have filed claims for debt relief because their school closed. Bob Agnew reporting.
Donald Trump has signed a Republican allegiance pledge that says he will not make a third-party White House bid. He had said at a GOP debate that he would keep his options open. That pledge is not legally binding. Trump says he sees no circumstances under which he would tear it up. More on these stories at townhall.com.
Hi, this is Ted Anderson. Have you ever wondered why banks, stockbrokers, investment advisors won't talk about gold IRAs? They've been available since 1986, yet the financial industry won't recognize the value of gold for your retirement. Gold has outperformed paper investments, yet no word about IRAs. If you would like to have gold for your retirement, call 800-686-2237. Don't get left behind by rising inflation and low returns. Call 800-686-2237. Secure your future and call 1-800-686-2237.
Paid non-attorney spokesperson Adam Pulaski of the Pulaski Law Firm with principal office in Houston, Texas is the attorney responsible for the content of this ad. This ad is not legal advice, and the choice of a lawyer should not be based solely upon advertisement. Services may not be available in all states.
Attention Xarelto users. If you or a loved one took Xarelto and suffered a serious bleeding event, you may be entitled to financial compensation. Xarelto is a popular prescription blood thinner used to prevent blood clots and protect patients from strokes. These serious bleeding events have led to numerous cases of hospitalization and even death. Phone lines are open 24/7. Call 800-261-0937. That's 800-261-0937.
Free Talk Live.
Free Talk Live. Numbers 855-450-3733. We've been talking about this Kim Davis woman. She is a clerk of the county court. That means it's an elected position.
Yes.
In a Kentucky county. And she has refused, because of her religious beliefs, to issue marriage licenses. I believe that that's why she's choosing to do this.
I believe that she believes that, okay. But she's not being at all consistent.
Belief is what this is about, and so I don't care whether she's being consistent. This is her religious belief, and I support her in her religious belief. However, I also believe that if she's going to have a job where part of the job description is to hand out marriage licenses, she probably should do that. I would like to point out, and I think this is important, is if you really wanted a marriage license, you'd drive the next county over and get one. So the people that are bringing this lawsuit are, they're making a stand. They have a point that they're trying to make, and that's, you know, obviously no change gets made by somebody who's not trying to make a point. So
right.
Your thought on it is welcome, 855-450-3733, excuse me. Let's go to Tom, who's calling in from Baltimore. Tom, you're on Free Talk Live.
Hi, gentlemen. I'm surprised that, given your general views on government overreach and freedom, that you've missed the big issue here and have gotten tangled up in a branch instead of striking at the root, which is, why in the world would anyone seek permission from a government entity to exercise human freedom and free will? In
other
words,
should have brought that up. Absolutely.
When licensing or requesting a license, you're asking a government entity for permission to do something, which you shouldn't have to. If you want to get married, whether you're Christian and believe one way or whether you're of another persuasion, then you should do what it is you feel you are under God's or anyone else's belief able to do.
I completely agree. Have you read the statutes in Kentucky regarding marriage?
No, I haven't.
There's a statute that says that two people cannot get married without a license. In New Hampshire, there's a statute that makes it a violation punishable by a $60 fine for a minister to solemnize a marriage without a license. So there are requirements in various places that you are required to get that piece of paper. Now, I don't think that that requirement should exist. I don't think that there should be government marriage licenses. But in the reality that we live in, there are requirements that people wishing to get married have to have that government marriage license. Otherwise, they face penalties themselves. And in the reality that we live in, government officials are supposed to give out those licenses to anyone who seeks a license and is, you know, not in violation of some other thing. So, you know, like if two 12-year-olds went in and said, "We want a marriage license," then the clerk would be right to say, "No, you don't get a marriage license." But two adults go in and say, "We want a marriage license because your law says that we have to have one," that government official should give them that marriage license. Now, again, I agree that the marriage license should not exist.
I think in every state there's issues relative to the state sanctioning. However, although I don't always agree with civil disobedience, I think when it comes to marriage, I would agree with civil disobedience. Again, be you a Christian
how
or
do you
not,
civilly disobe- how do you be civilly disobedient in that way?
You don't get the license when you go into a
that's
marriage.
That's not civil disobedience. That's living together.
Simply go to your pastor or whomever it is that you believe can sanction a marriage and have it done absent the state.
Okay, well, I wouldn't call that civil disobedience, but that's fine. That's a non-state marriage. And, you know, I support people getting those. It's certainly a lot less complicated to undo if you have to do that, too. When you include the state in your marriage, you can expect the state to be involved in your marriage. And when, generally, when the state's involved in something, people are unhappy about that. So don't get the state involved in your marriage if you don't want the state involved in your marriage.
Contracting will get you in trouble every time.
Thanks for the call, Tom. Appreciate it. And he's absolutely right that we should have brought that up. That George and Martha Washington, they didn't have a marriage license. They had their preacher man wrote something in their Bible and recorded the marriage.
Right.
I just did a Quaker wedding. You don't really do a Quaker. I don't know how to describe this. I was present at a Quaker wedding and involved in the marrying in the ceremony of two people being married. And I was surprised at how short the vows are for Quakers. I mean, it was just, you know, I take thee as my wedded wife, and I promise to love and be faithful to you all of your days. And it's just like that long. And then the wife says something to the same effect, and, you know, it doesn't have that love, honor, and cherish. Quakers have always been about equality anyway. So it's the same promise on both sides. And that was it. That was as the long as the vows were. There were parts of it where, you know, different parts that went on, but there you go.
Yeah, there's going to be an outlaw. I prefer the term outlaw wedding instead of stateless wedding. There's going to be an outlaw wedding in about a month that I'm going to be presiding over. I'm meeting with the couple in about another week and a half. We're going to go over their ceremony. And, you know, I'm going to show them, here's a couple of the ceremonies that I have done before. Here's what I can do. And sort of let them lead me and tell me what they want out of the wedding. But yeah, it's not going to have government license. Outlaw wedding.
Let's go to Eric calling from Montana. Eric, you're on Free Talk Live.
Yes, hi. I wanted to talk about the same issue.
Okay.
Sorry to beat a dead horse here.
Yep. That's what we do on Free Talk Live. We beat dead horses.
I know.
That's how you tenderize them.
Very good. My partner and I, of 30 years here in Montana, we never believed in getting married, period.
So, partner, let me clarify this, because partner can mean a few things, especially from Montana. So, partner could be somebody that you call any old buddy if you're a cowboy, right? Or it could be your business partner, or it could be your life partner. And oftentimes, if it's your life partner,
we happen to be all of them.
Okay.
All of the above.
Is it a male or female life partner?
A male partner.
Okay, got it.
And unfortunately, he passed away a year ago.
Sorry to hear that, Eric.
Thank you. But then this is the reason why I'm calling. We were both libertarians. I'm still libertarian. We didn't want no license from the government. Didn't believe in any of that garbage. Until he ended up in a coma in the hospital. Suddenly, decisions had to be made. I wasn't allowed to make them. The hospital insisted on contacting his sisters, his oldest sister, who he hadn't even talked to in almost 30 years. I had never even met her, to have her decide whether to keep him on the machine or take him off. And it was totally wrong. Totally wrong. No respect for us as human beings, being together 30 years.
Did they have the civil union thing there in Montana
no.
at the time? Okay. So there was just nothing.
No. Montana never had civil unions.
This is one of the reasons why I supported gay marriage, these situations right here. I know there's a lot of issues about sort of money and government insurance and things like that. And, you know, I'm not concerned about those things, but I am concerned about, you know, somebody being able to make decisions for their loved one and that's what their loved one would want. Now, oftentimes you can file paperwork ahead of time to sort of cover these things, but a lot of times people don't think about those things. Go ahead, Eric.
Well, unfortunately, you have to have it in Montana. Each hospital that you're going to be seen in needs to have that paperwork, and they want their own paperwork, not a standardized paperwork.
Hmm.
I guess you're going to a break. Huh?
Yeah, so you support gay marriage, and you didn't support it before, is that right?
Correct, and we did get married before he passed away. We had to go to Seattle when he was on his deathbed.
In order
to protect our rights.
That feels a little bit better. Thank you so much, Eric. 855-450-3733. It's 855-450-FREE. Think Eric should go to jail for that?
Are you suffering with hearing loss? Are you sick of people constantly complaining that your TV is too loud? Are you tired of asking people to speak up? Would you like to hear more clearly, but you don't want to wear a hearing aid that makes you look old? Then you need to try Listen Clear, a life-changing breakthrough precisely designed by top audio engineers to fit your ear almost invisibly. And you can adjust Listen Clear to find the perfect way to hear everything, wherever you are, and whatever you're doing. And right now, you can try Listen Clear absolutely risk-free with free shipping. We'll even give you free batteries for life. So call now, 1-800-719-9349. Listen Clear is lightweight and completely hassle-free, and it's practically invisible. Call for your 100% risk-free home trial with free shipping and free batteries for life. For free information, call now, 1-800-719-9349. That's 1-800-719-9349. 1-800-719-9349.
Again, the Congressional Budget Office sounds the alarm. This time warns of Greek-style U.S. debt crises. You heard me right. The GAO is drawing a parallel between the U.S. economy, its debt, and the current Greek economic meltdown. With the debt-to-GDP chart climbing into unfamiliar territory, the growing budget deficit will rise to unsupportable levels. Hi, this is Ted Anderson. The Federal Debt and Risk of Financial Crises document the CBO has published is a must-read for every American. Covering the risk of continued deficit spending coupled with an aging population and the rising interest rates spell economic disaster. It's imperative that you get a copy of this document and study it for yourself. Call me today at 800-686-2237, and I'll send you a free copy. Again, call 800-686-2237 and ask for your copy of the CBO document. Once again, you need to read this government report. Call 800-686-2237.
Okay, open your mouth and say, ah.
Ah.
When your child has a sore throat, you need to know when to get help. The doctor recommended Say-Aw Sore Throat Exam is your solution. The scientifically designed oral retractor offers a clear view of the throat, relaxing the tongue and minimizing gag reflex. Compare with a medical grade chart, website, and app. Then you'll know just what to tell your doctor. A wellness plan in your hands in minutes. Go to sayahnow.com. Sayahnow.com, the new mainstay for every family's first aid kit.
Do you owe $10,000 or more to the IRS?
Then get on board with the Tax Admiral and let us steer your way to financial freedom.
The IRS is the largest collection agency in the world. They can freeze your bank accounts, seize your car, home, will garnish your paychecks and benefits.
Don't take on the IRS alone. I can fight for you using industry secrets that can help stop the IRS. I'll cut your penalties, slash your interest, and reduce your overall tax bill. Sometimes I can even get it zeroed out completely.
We're an A-rated company with over 30 years experience helping people clean up their mess with the IRS. And we have a 95% customer satisfaction rating.
If you owe $10,000 or more to the IRS, are facing an audit, a lien, or levy, then call me right away.
Call 800-287-7180. Again, that's 800-287-7180. 800-287-7180. 800-287-7180.
This is Dan Pilla. Do you owe the IRS money you can't pay? Are tax debts crippling you? I've defended people from the IRS for over 30 years. I've helped thousands, and I can help you too. I wrote the book on IRS settlement, and I'm telling you, there's no such thing as a hopeless case. Call 800-34-NO-TAX to finally get free of IRS debt. With the IRS's new programs, there's never been a better time to solve your problem. Call 800-34-NO-TAX That's 800-34-NO-TAX or my website, danpilla.com.
Now more Free Talk Live. Call in toll-free at 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-FREE.
Talk Live, 855-450-3733. It's 855-453. You can call in, talk about, well, whatever you want to talk about. We've been talking about this Kim Davis gal, the county clerk, clerk of the county court, who's, well, she's in the pokey. She's in the big house, the cooler, because she didn't follow the orders of the court and hand out the marriage licenses to, well, anybody, really, at this point. It's really seems to be about the gay folks, but at this point, it's about anybody.
Right, and I still think that her claim of my religion says I can't give marriage licenses would have been a lot stronger had she stopped issuing marriage licenses as soon as she took office after being elected last year.
Well, if you are interested in Bitcoin the same way I am, you might want to do like I've done and sign up for Bitcoinist.net's daily email. It's the ultimate resource for the Bitcoin industry news, reviews, education, the latest in the cryptocurrency ecosystem. Bitcoinist is the prime online destination for information about the Bitcoin and digital currency industry. Their website integrates a community forum breaking Bitcoin and digital currency news. They also aim to cover fintech and blockchain tech news as well. Bitcoinist has very sophisticated Bitcoin network statistics, a solid beginner's guide to Bitcoin, and much more. Their platform serves the needs of everyone trying to keep up with Bitcoin and digital currencies, from beginners to experts, Bitcoinist.net.
And there's one piece of information that I have not mentioned about Kim Davis, the Rowan County clerk. You guys both mentioned that a lot of the Republican presidential candidates are coming out in support of this woman. That opens up a giant scandal because Kim Davis is a Democrat.
Oh, no.
Eh.
That's funny.
I'm just wondering, would they have like a quiz down there, you know, for this religious thing? Like, well, the little Lord and baby Jesus, he's got a question, and he's very young. He shouldn't be knowing these kinds of things, but he wants to know, have you, as a couple, Mr., Miss, have you ever had anything but vaginal intercourse? Oh, you have? Well, you're sodomites. You can't get married.
Look, this is, it seems to me that Christianity today is hyper-focused on homosexuality.
Yes.
And I, you know, if you want to be focused on homosexuality, I don't know what that says about you, but I believe that people have the right to their religious beliefs, even if they're contrary to my understanding of their holy doctrine, even if they're contrary to the way I was raised, even if any of this stuff. It's your religion, you get to have it. I got nothing to say about Kim's Davis's religion or the fact that she's had three husbands and children out of wedlock and whatever it was that she's done.
Clearly, if you have sexual relations in any other position than the missionary position, you are of the devil.
But you don't get to enforce, through force, your religious beliefs on other people.
I wouldn't want to. And that's
But that's
problem.
What this woman is doing.
She sure is.
And there have been a lot of people say she should be fired. Well, it's not that easy because it's an elected position. There are two ways to remove her from office. The first way is through the courts, where she winds up getting convicted of certain offenses, and then the attorney general can remove her because she's in jail and unable to do her job. Or the state legislature, the Kentucky General Assembly, can remove her from office, but they're not convening until January, and the governor says this is too expensive to call, or rather it's too expensive to call a special session just to decide whether or not to remove this woman as county clerk.
So yeah. I have a religious technical question for you, Darryl. So let's presuppose it's a straight couple and they're having sex and it's missionary position and it's vaginal intercourse, but the sheets that they're using are a mix of different fibers. Are they sodomites?
I don't know. I'm still curious what gomorrhoe is.
So sodomy versus gomorrhoe. Yeah, that's funny. It's interesting that Sodom gets all of the blame and Gomorrah really doesn't get much of it.
Yeah.
Nonetheless.
Or maybe gomorrhoe is just that horrible of a thing that like we can't even put into words what it is.
So there's another story here I've got. Apparently, this is from Reason's Hit and Run blog. A North Carolina 17-year-old caught in a sexting scandal faces charges of sexually exploiting a minor that could land him in jail for up to 10 years, since the law considers him an adult. But one of the minors he's supposedly exploited is himself, which raises an obvious question.
Wait, how... one of the minors? You mean the only minor?
Well, I mean, he took pictures of him and a young lady. And
oh, there was somebody else.
Yeah, that's my understanding of the situation. It you know, raises an obvious question. How can a teen be old enough to face adult felony charges, but not old enough to keep a nude picture of himself on his phone? And this is a very, like, he's going to be an adult for the purposes of sentencing and trial, but a kid for the purposes of the crime. Makes no sense. Unfortunately, that's the Kafka-esque nightmare in which Fayetteville area high schooler Cormega Copening finds himself in after exchanging private nude photos with his girlfriend, with whom he is legally allowed to have sex, but not allowed to sext. This is another problem, is if you're, say, 16 years old and you're allowed to have sex in whatever state you happen to be in, but you can't take pictures of that, and you can't send pictures, this is the complications we have of all these laws surrounding what arbitrary ages people can have sex. From 14 to 18 basically seem to be the numbers.
I mean, the reality here, the real root of this issue here is, you know, first of all, the control of the laws and the power that's, you know, it's just overarching. But, I mean, it also comes down to just when you think about it, the politicians writing these laws are just dummies. I mean, they're just dumb people.
Right.
And they can't even come close to getting a law right.
Well, the problem is a lot of times it's not the politicians that are actually writing the laws.
Right.
So in New Hampshire, the way it works is a legislator goes to the legislative services office and says, I would like a law about fill in the blank. And they will sort of direct the legislative services office what they want. Legislative services then comes up with a proposal and says, here you go. The representative then signs off on it. Legislative service will not tell this person, oh, by the way, this conflicts with 27 other statutes. They just say, here's the proposal you wanted.
Right.
So there was a proposal last year that would have moved the primary election day in New Hampshire. And I happen to know that there's a lot of other things that are tied to the primary election day, such as the petitioning requirement. So that would have moved the petitioning deadline to early February. And numerous courts have ruled that petitioning deadlines before June are illegally unconstitutional. But legislative service never told this state rep. He was like, I had no clue.
There you go. I don't know what to say about it.
They're not writing the bills.
855-450-3733.
Or reading them.
3733. It's 855-450-FREE. About this teen boy who's... well, facing adult charges for pictures of himself, what do you think? 855-450-3733. Does anybody support this crap? 855-450-FREE, Free Talk Live.
So I say to Mark at lunch, look, you know, I keep hearing from the government that, you know, they're worried someday ISIS may get here. And I go, duh, Garland, Texas, Muhammad cartoon shooting, ISIS is already here. I'm not waiting for these people to defend me. If they don't know ISIS is here already, they got no clue, I'm taking care of myself. Guns80.com, AR-15 kits, 30-shot magazines, great prices. They've even got the Hillary special. Guns80.com, that's 844-2-GUNS80, Guns80.com.
You are an individual with your own thoughts, decisions, and actions. So why should you be penalized for not enrolling in the subpar health insurance mandated by the government? Be truly independent. Visit LibertyOnCall.org. LibertyOnCall.org is a bold, innovative alternative allowing you to take back control and make your own decisions about your health care. Mention this ad when you call to learn more. 800-714-6993. That's 800-714-6993. LibertyOnCall.org. Call today.
Hi, my name is Scott Fuchs, teacher and rowing coach for over 14 years. I was sluggish, overweight, on prescription drugs, and only 30-something. Fortunately, I was referred to Dr. Z, and happy to say Dr. Z's all-natural protocols over a consistent course resolved my health issues. I'm in the best shape of my life, and most importantly, on zero medications.
I'm Dr. Zdanowski, author of Evology, trained as a primary care physician, surgical manipulation under anesthesia, expert in nutrition, diet, weight loss, immune system, and I specialize in chiropractic. My 15 years of professional experience has taught me the four keys to vibrant health: a balanced musculoskeletal system, an integrated nervous system, a flowing lymphatic system, and a body filled with over 90 essential nutrients. This has been a secret too long. Actualize your potential, reverse disease. Call me, Dr. Z. 201-945-1177, 201-945-1177, evolveyourself.com.
Owe $10,000 or more to the IRS?
Get on board with the Tax Admiral. Don't take on the IRS alone. I'll cut penalties and reduce your overall tax bill. Sometimes I can even get it zeroed out completely.
We're an A-rated company helping people clean up their mess with the IRS.
If you owe $10,000 or more, then call the Tax Admiral.
Call 800-287-7180. Again, that's 800-287-7180. 800-287-7180.
It's time to build your own emergency food stockpile with the industry leader, My Patriot Supply. Once you try them, you'll know why so many Americans like you have made them part of their emergency preparedness plan. Experience the My Patriot Supply difference today with this unbelievable offer. Right now, a four-week food supply is only $99, and that includes free shipping. That's 50% off the online price. Call 800-274-3070 to claim yours. Limit two per caller while supplies last. This offer isn't available online, so you want to make sure and grab this opportunity to get prepared today. 800-274-3070 to get your four-week food supply for the incredible price of only $99, and it'll be shipped to you completely free. Call 800-274-3070 right now. That's 800-274-3070 to claim yours while supplies last. Don't wait. Call today.
We use mobile devices right against our bodies every day, but growing scientific evidence has emerged showing serious health risks associated with exposure to EMF radiation emitted from these devices. The solution is Defender Shield, the most effective mobile radiation shielding ever developed. Defender Shield blocks virtually 100% of EMF radiation from cell phones, tablets, and laptops, and starts at just $64.99. Buy now at DefenderShield.com. For 10% off, use promo code GCN. DefenderShield.com, the worldwide leader in mobile radiation shielding.
This is Free Talk Live. Call in toll free. 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-FREE.
Free Talk Live. 855-450-3733. Young man in near Fayetteville been charged as an adult for exploiting a minor. At the very least, one of the minors that he's supposed to be exploiting is himself. So he's being charged for exploiting himself, which is weird, but he's being charged as an adult for exploiting himself as a minor.
Yeah, totally sounds like the John Fogerty sued John Fogerty for plagiarism because John Fogerty wrote a song that was too much like a song John Fogerty wrote.
This is too dumb. I'm sorry. This is even dumber than that. That's a music label suing another music label because they own the rights to one song and another song. I mean, there's at least something that makes sense behind it. In this case, this is legal land.
Yeah,
legal
land.
Both of them are legal
idiots.
Land.
What's that?
This is just purely government idiots being idiots and imposing their will on other people.
Yeah, I'm going to go on here with his story. To recap, Copeland and his girlfriend, now identified, well, I'm not going to identify her here. There's no particular reason. They are like any other teenagers in that they have more than a passing interest in sex. Indeed, When they were 16, they were engaged. They exchanged racy, sexy photos via text message. Denson, that's the girlfriend, sorry about that, sent pictures to Coping, and Coping sent pictures to Denson. And it appears that no one else saw the pictures until local authorities searched Coping's phone and discovered them. Why did they search his phone? It's not clear, but, well, because they could. But local news reports claim that it had nothing to do with the sex themselves. Cumberland County Sheriff's Office did not respond to a request for comment, and according to the Fayette Observer here, there's no record of a search warrant being issued for Coping's phone. Both teens were charged with sexual exploitation, I guess, of each other. Hard to do that. Denson pleaded guilty to a lesser charge and was given 12 months of probation. That's the girl. Coping, however, is still facing 2 counts of second-degree sexual exploitation and 3 counts of third-degree sexual exploitation. As Tom Meyer points out, the third-degree charges, which constitute a majority of the total charges, actually stem from pictures Coping had of himself. Implication is clear. Coping does not own himself, and from the standpoint of the law, he is not free to keep sexually provocative pictures, even if they depict his own body. But consider this, North Carolina is one of 2 states in the country, the other is progressive New York, that considers 16 to be the age of adulthood for criminal purposes. This means, of course, that Coping can be tried as an adult for exploiting a minor himself.
My brain is still trying to comprehend the lunacy of this whole thing, and I'm trying to figure out why his phone was searched.
Well, they searched his phone because they could. It was part of a, they were just kind of poking around looking for stuff. They said, they wanted to be able to look at the kid's phone. So they did. And that's basically that.
Johnson?
I don't know. I mean, it's just too crazy for me. I mean, the whole situation is just this type of lunacy keeps happening and needs to stop. I mean, it happens over and over and over again.
And the girlfriend, by the way, has taken the plea and gotten 12 months probation, which I sincerely hope she can make it all the way through that. But
is this kid going to have to register as a sex offender for the rest of his life? Because he has pictures of himself.
Depends. Depends on the situation, the charge, and the state, and that sort of thing. It says here, there's no evidence the phones were ever sent to anyone else. The photos were ever sent to anyone else. The police only became aware of them because they were searching Coping's phone for unrelated reasons that have not been specified. So that's all we know, Daryl.
Yeah, and I saw a picture of this young man, and if it's the same one, he's a young black male.
He looks like he could be black, yeah.
Yeah, chances are he was walking down the street, and as cops are wont to do, they probably approached him and started asking questions, and because he doesn't know all of his rights or know how to exercise his rights, he probably, I want to get out of this, so I'll just do whatever they say, because otherwise I might get shot, because that happens a lot. And they're like, oh, we need to look in your phone. Chances are they were trying to find text messages that, he may have been buying or selling some drugs. And they're like, oh, what's this? Looks like a wiener here.
Yep.
Whose wiener is this? He's like, that's mine. And they're like, okay. And it's a naked female. So now we've got you on a bunch of things.
Yeah. Well, and they're pointing out that these third degree charges are charges stemming from him having pictures of himself. So not only are they charging him for pictures of her, but they're charging specifically. There are charges specific to him and his pictures.
Right, and that's probably just a because we can sort of charge.
Well,
that's what a lot of the charges are. It's because we can, and we'll use that as a poker chip at the sort of negotiating table when we say, hey, listen, kid, right now, what is it, 4 or 5 charges he's facing? And they'll say, we'll pull 3 of these charges off if you plead to this other one.
Sure, they do that.
I hope
constantly.
He's smart enough to push that through to a jury trial, because there's no way that would go through in a jury trial.
I hope you're right. Yeah. I don't trust juries at all.
There was a trial in Manchester, which is the largest city in New Hampshire, a couple of years ago, where several members of Occupy New Hampshire were arrested for trespassing in a city park. Because they were there at 11:15 and the park closed at 11 o'clock. They were arrested. They said, you know what, we're going to take this thing to court, try and get the courts to overturn the curfew that you can't be in a city park after 11 o'clock. They were convicted by a jury. I, along with Ian Freeman, questioned one member of the jury after the hearing. It was the only member of the jury that would talk to us.
They just wanted to get out of there, didn't they? They just wanted to go home.
That and, well, they told us what the law was, and we wanted to uphold the law. And I specifically asked the question, I said, do you think this jury would have convicted Martin Luther King and Gandhi for violating laws? And she said, yes. Yes, they would.
Yeah.
So, no, I don't believe that a jury is going to look at this and say, this is absolutely ridiculous, not guilty. They'll look at it and say, this is absolutely ridiculous, but guilty. He had all those pictures, so guilty.
Yeah. I do not trust juries, not one bit. If you can get one powerful person on that jury that believes in their mission to make sure that they don't send innocent people to jail— then you're in pretty good shape because that one person can hang the jury.
I don't think juries are told that's their mission. I think juries are told that their mission is to follow the law as the judge gives it to them.
Right, but I don't care what the judge says. The judge is just an unsuccessful lawyer sitting around in a black muumuu.
Right, and the people on the jury are people that are too dumb to have gotten out of jury duty for the most part.
Well, look, if you sit on a jury and you send a person that you don't believe should go to prison to prison— You suck.
Yes, but most people suck. Right.
But most of the people that they get on the juries, I mean, they probably like, you know, filter them out by asking them, what's 80 divided by 8? Well, I'm not really quite sure the answer to that one. Perfect. You're on our jury. You know, because we can control you because you are a mindless automaton drone.
Well, what we can see is that far fewer than 1% of cases of arrests result in trials. Of the felony charges that we can see, one-third of people are found to be not guilty and two-thirds are found to be guilty. Now, I would assume that cops are making much larger mistakes than less than 1%. So, you know, I would assume that there's a lot of innocent people that are taking plea bargains simply yes. because it's too difficult to get through the process. That makes sense to me. And I can't believe that our stalwart paladins of justice are just that smart. These C-plus students that, you know, that the best job they could get was copdom. Yes, there certainly are some people that aspired to copdom. That's what they wanted. But no one's going to claim that they're rocket scientists. And, you know, I don't think for one second that in these situations, I don't trust the juries. So I don't know. What do you think about it? What do you think? 855-450-3733, 855-450-FREE. It's clear and obvious that this young man should not be charged as an adult for having naked pictures of himself, but he is. And do you think the jury will find him guilty?
Golly, look at that black robe. It's so shiny and beautiful.
855-450-3733. Free Talk Live.
Majestic.
Every once in a while, you get information that's worth changing your life for. This is one such time. You can save up to and beyond 25% on all purchases at Amazon. You probably heard of Bitcoin and just not thought much about it. You certainly know that you can get competitive pricing at Amazon, but now you can get a 25% discount on nearly everything you need to live. I've just given you a huge raise, and all you have to do is claim it. You go to purse.freetalklive.com and open an account. Do this right now, don't wait. Then you fund the account with Bitcoin. You can buy them through expresscoin.com with a check or money order. There are other ways to get Bitcoin, but that's fast, safe, and easy. This information is worth you changing the way you do things. Go to purse.freetalklive.com right now and get signed up and cash in on the huge raise I'm offering you. 25% off of everything on Amazon through purse.freetalklive.com. It's purse.freetalklive.com.
We are a survival company. We manufacture our own line of Level 3 and Level 3A body armor. We proudly make our armor 100% in America. We have the best prices in the nation, about $125 cheaper than our nearest competitor. All lab certified, for thou art my rock and my fortress, Psalm 31:3. We are Fortress Survival LLC.com.
Are your Google search results killing you? Unflattering content in blogs, news articles, online reviews, social media, or other sources can jeopardize your reputation, your business, and your livelihood. Let Reputation.com help. Our patented technology will make the truth about you more visible while pushing down unwanted negative content. Improve your Google search results. Call Reputation.com at 1-800-831-0771 for a free consultation. That's 800-831-0771.
KatieArmor.com is your one-stop shop for the most affordable body armor period. With packages starting at $169.99 and free shipping on every order, Katie offers soft armor and rifle threat rated armor up to level 4. Go to KatieArmor.com and get your body armor today while you still can. Mention this ad and receive a free tactical scarf for a limited time with any body armor package. That's CATIArmor.com. Come and take it.
Are you tired of commuting to a job that makes someone else rich, working harder than ever, but getting nowhere? Do you hate spending hundreds of dollars every week on daycare, having someone else raise your children? With our opportunities, you can start earning money as soon as next week. You get to be the boss, work from home, and live a happier life. At Be the Boss Network, you'll find hundreds of work-from-home opportunities that you can literally start today and be earning money as soon as next week. Go to freedom106.com and start earning money as soon as next week. You get to be the boss. Get out of the rat race. Work from home. Go to freedom106.com right now and change your life today. That's freedom, the number 106.com. Go to freedom106.com and start earning money as soon as next week. You be the boss. Go to freedom106.com.
By now, you know the smart way to buy emergency food storage is calories per dollar. Ready Supply Foods sells you 50% more food for your money. GMO-free, 25-year shelf life, great tasting, and free shipping. You need 2,000 calories per day under ideal conditions. Most 30-day kits don't have enough calories to sustain you for more than a week. They just don't have enough nutrition to do the job. See the comparisons for yourself at ReadySupplyFoods.com. We are the new leader in value and quality. Go to ReadySupplyFoods.com today.
You're listening to Free Talk Live. Call in toll-free at 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-FREE.
It's 855-450-FREE. Just finished up this story of this teen who was charged as an adult for possessing nude pictures of himself as an underage person. None of this makes any sense, but you can comment on it. 855-450-FREE, Free Talk Live. If you're going to be on the internet like this young man, ProXPN's the way to go. If you care about your privacy, you need ProXPN. It's a virtual private network that encrypts all of your online data even before it gets to your internet service provider. They do all of it right in offering OpenVPN. That's the gold standard of network encryption. They have apps for Windows, Mac, iOS, Android, Linux. Plus, unlike those other guys, ProXPN keeps no logs of your activities whatsoever. ProXPN even has even more servers than before, giving you greater speed and security. They accept credit card and even Bitcoin. You can get 50% off the regular monthly price for the lifetime of the account when you buy an annual account with our code FTL50. It can end up being cheaper per month than a good cup of coffee. You keep hearing about our online privacy being infringed? Well, go to ProXPN.com now. Use coupon code FTL50 and take back the privacy that is your right. ProXPN.com. Coupon code FTL50. So, Johnson.
Yes.
Flag burning. It's a good way to whip up the masses. Flag burning.
Apparently, Donald Trump, if he had his way, it would be against the law to burn the American flag.
Maybe he should burn anybody who burns the flag at the stake.
Yeah, sure. Should he do that? Really? Is that
maybe.
Maybe. Okay. Well, according to this article by Jamie Weinstein, The billionaire businessman and Republican presidential frontrunner made the comment in an extensive interview with the Daily Caller that covered a wide array of subjects. The interview will be published soon. He says, "Personally, I don't think it should be legal," Trump told the D.C., speaking of the burning American flag question. "Let me ask you a question. It didn't used to be legal, did it? I see more and more burning of the flag. Did it used to be legal?" So
hold on. Before
it's
you,
it's a good conservative argument.
Continue. It's perfectly legal to burn an American flag, and it's actually the proper way to get rid of a damaged or destroyed American flag. Is you set fire to it?
Yeah,
the Boy Scouts of America have ceremonies all the time where they burn American flags. Does Donald Trump want to send Boy Scouts to jail? Why does Donald Trump hate Boy Scouts?
It is true that the flag burning is essentially among the most sacred acts for those that think the flags are important, and the most sacrilegious act at the same time.
Well, burning the flag was illegal for parts of American history, but Supreme Court decisions in 1989 and 1990 declared that desecrating the stars and stripes was protected under the First Amendment of the Constitution.
It's settled law.
Yeah. "People burning the flag, I don't like them in this country," Trump added. Trump has said that he switched from being pro-choice to being a pro-lifer after knowing that his family... I'm not even going to get into this. This is more stuff on the article. He talks about Trump's views. But I just wanted to bring up the point about burning of the flag and what general people's views are on burning the flag.
Well, specifically Donald Trump's. I mean, this guy's leading the Republican pack out there, and his opinion's a bit important. He certainly... A lot of people feel like they're...
"I'm the only one in this country that should be able to speak my mind. Everyone else, if you're doing something that I don't like, you should just have to shut up and be thrown in a jail cell."
If you don't like it, leave.
Right.
It's the old, "You don't like it here, go to Somalia" thing that's always told the libertarians.
If you don't like it, drive one county west and get your marriage license there, huh, Mark?
I'm just saying, if you want a marriage license, you can get it there.
If you say something I don't like, you're fired.
You're fired. this is an old one, the flag burning thing, but it gets a lot of people whipped up. And I think it's because of the military, right? Like, they've got oftentimes relatives, sons, fathers.
You didn't fight for what that flag represents.
And they...
And your freedom. They fought and died for your freedom to do what you're saying. With the burning of the flag there.
And they see that people died,
it's
right?
Like, well, obviously, clearly, they didn't fight for my right to do this.
Right.
They lost. So they actually fought for nothing because people like you go around saying that people can't burn flags.
Yeah.
So they didn't fight for any rights and freedoms. They fought for slavery and...
Well, nationalism.
Nationalism.
Yeah, nationalism or...
Which is a form of...
Jingoism, depending on how you want to look at it. I don't think that that's... it ain't a way to have freedoms. It's not the same thing. So you may or may not be a big flag supporter, but ultimately people need to be able to burn flags in whatever form of protest they wish to. Now,
so,
consider it needs to be their flag, and it needs to be someplace where, it's burning is safe.
Right. That's what I was going to say. It boils down to who owns the flag. If the person goes to Walmart and they pay $19.95 plus tax for a flag that was made in China that's got 50 stars, 13 stripes, do they own that flag? And if so, are they allowed to do with that flag as they choose? I say yes and yes. That includes they can soak it in gasoline and light it on fire if that's what they want to do, because they own that flag. That flag does not belong to society as a whole. That flag belongs to the person that bought it.
Yeah, pretty obvious. That American flag that was made in China belongs to the American that bought it and set it on fire with matches that were probably made in Mexico.
I wonder what would happen, though, if the American flag burning, like specifically burning, was outlawed. I mean, how soon would you see demonstrations where it's like, "Come let your dog defecate on this flag. You know, we're out here in the park and we need, people bring your dog poop over here. We'll pick it up for you with this American flag." Or, hey, we've got a shredder here. We're out in public. We got a nice, you know, industrial grade shredder. Come throw your flags into our shredder.
Or you simply wind up finding a flag manufacturer that will make a flag with 11 stripes and 49 stars. Not the American flag,
right. But
you're going to have some people that are getting all upset. You can't burn the American flag because America is America. And then you tell them, this isn't the American flag, and then they'll get even more upset.
Oh, tell them it is. It's not a legal lie object. About it being the American flag. You didn't actually burn the American flag. Doesn't matter if you tell people it is. Let the stupid people believe what they want.
But no, they'll just get even more upset when you tell them that it's not.
No, I'd say tell them that it is and then burn it and let them be all upset and then find out later when they can't do anything to you because it wasn't actually the American flag.
Or there'd be special flags sold for burning.
Sure.
Yeah.
It's your burning flag.
Obama flags with 52 stars instead of 50. 57, whatever it is. Yeah.
And the whole thing on the 57 states, if you listen to what he said, he was off by 10, not by 7. He said, I've been to, I think, 57 states. There's one left to go, plus Alaska and Hawaii that my campaign staff won't let me go to. So his total number was 60. So the idiots that said, we need to add 7 more stars, they're the idiots because they didn't listen to all of what he said to figure out that he was off by 10, not 7.
I think it makes a lot more sense to be off by 10 than it, it's much more excusable to say 50, you've been in 57 states than to say 47, if that makes sense.
Right.
It's just much more excusable.
Because he had been to 40, at the time he said that, he had been to 47. There was one more state he was going to visit, which would have made it 48. Then there were two that his campaign staff would not have let him go to because of expense.
Well, I understand why people went after him for that one, because poor Bush got beat up all the time for his sort of, just saying things wrong and that
true
kind of thing.
And most of the time the stuff that Bush said, if you listen to the context, it wasn't as stupid as what it sounded like.
So I mean, if people are going to play those games, they're going to get the results of those games, which
is, I'm going to point it out to both of them that they're being stupid idiots,
dumb political games.
Mission accomplished. I'm the decider.
So which one do you think it's going to be? Do you think it's going to be Hillary or Bush? You got any thoughts?
I'm if those are the two choices, I'm probably going to write in none of the above.
You got a prediction? I'm not asking what you would like, who you're going to vote for. I'm asking for a prediction.
I don't care. There have been polls that have come out, and they're sort of neck and neck, but the way they do the opinion polls don't really matter, because unless you're looking at polls from every state to figure out who's getting electoral votes from where, that's how you really determine who it is projected to
be. I think it's
going to
end up being Carly Fiorina versus Bernie Sanders.
Worst things could happen to us, I suppose. 855-450-3733. It's 855-450-FREE. Free Talk Live.
Are you searching for your soulmate? Someone you can trust, who will never betray you or cooperate with the NSA? Stop searching. With EasyDNS, you found a keeper. EasyDNS does it all. Domain names, web hosting, and managed WordPress hosting. EasyDNS stands up for your internet freedom. And with servers in Canada, they do not cooperate with the NSA. Go to EasyDNS.com. You'll love their services or get a full refund. They guarantee it. And they accept Bitcoin. That's EasyDNS.com.
Here's a good idea. When you have a legal matter like creating your will or legally setting up a business with a corporation or LLC, you don't necessarily need a law firm. Use LegalZoom.com. At LegalZoom.com, you answer straightforward questions online and they take care of the rest. They even review your answers for common mistakes and guarantee your satisfaction. Free Talk Live listeners, you'll get 10% off your order by typing in FTL in the referral box at purchase. Don't procrastinate with these important legal documents. LegalZoom.com.
Quantitative easing, unemployment at depression levels, Europe financial system falling apart, China getting out of U.S. treasuries. At the end of 2008, the time of TARP, the national debt was at $11 trillion, gold trading around $850 per ounce. Close to 2012, the national debt exceeded $16.4 trillion, gold doubled to $1,600 per ounce. The $20 trillion threshold for the national debt is inevitable. Politicians in Washington have a ferocious appetite for spending and stimulus. What's worse, a printing press to finance. 100 years ago, we had a gold standard to limit this madness, but now you have to adopt your own gold standard. Don't be fooled with paper promises. Get Midas Resources 10 Reasons to Buy Gold free by calling 800-686-2237. Understanding the gold and silver market may be the only insurance you could have to avoiding the next economic crisis. Call 1-800-686-2237 and order your free copy. Again, that's 800-686-2237.
You're listening to GCN. Visit GCNlive.com today.
Breaking news this hour from townhall.com. I'm Keith Peters. Rowan County, Kentucky Clerk Kim Davis once again refused a judge's order to issue marriage licenses to homosexual couples, and she is now in jail. Davis told the judge today that she could not issue the licenses because it violates her Christian beliefs. One of Davis's attorneys, Matt Staver, is aghast at what happened today.
It's absolutely reprehensible that instead of ordering a very simple change of a computer-printed certificate, removing her name, the judge chooses instead to incarcerate her.
U.S. District Judge David Bunning told Davis she will be jailed until she complies with his order to issue the licenses. Presidential candidate Donald Trump has signed the pledge issued by Republican officials that he will support the GOP nominee. Trump says RNC Chairman Reince Priebus showed him the respect he wanted.
I wanted fairness. I don't have to be treated any differently than anybody else. I just wanted fairness from the Republican Party.
He says he's committed to staying with the GOP, but the pledge is not legally enforceable. The White House is ignoring the latest claims by Iran's top leader about the nuclear deal.
Iran's supreme leader claims there will be no deal if world powers insist on suspending rather than lifting sanctions as part of the nuclear agreement. Spokesman Josh Earnest offered a White House response.
We've been crystal clear about the fact that Iran will have to take a variety of serious steps to significantly roll back their nuclear program before any sanctions relief is offered.
He also said that the Obama administration would focus on Tehran's actions and not its words. Greg Clugston, The White House.
Police say three men have been shot and one of them has died near a baseball field on the campus of Sacramento City College in California. Police say the campus is on lockdown while they search for a suspect with no shirt wearing cargo shorts. On Wall Street, the Dow by 23 points, the NASDAQ down 16. On townhall.com.
Two little tablets is all it takes to get thicker, fuller hair guaranteed. Viviscal is the number one drug-free hair growth supplement.
We're talking.
Free Talk Live, 855-450-3733. I don't hear the music, but I suppose that could be okay. I don't know.
Internet could have gone out. It's happened a couple times in the last couple of nights.
Yeah, we could. Anything could be happening, far as I know. Anyway, it's you can call in and talk about whatever you want to talk about on the show here. And I've got another story that I think is worth bringing up. Apparently, according to AL.com.
That's Alabama Live.
Alabama Live.
Yeah. I'm from there, and the website came out when
what
I was...
What is Alabama Live?
That's what they call the website.
Is it a news agency, or...?
It started off as a news aggregator where they just pick stories from all of the different newspapers in the state, but they have since become not only a news aggregator, but a content creator, so they have their own staff that works there now that will do original pieces.
Okay. Well, according to this, I guess Pornhub is offering a scholarship, and it's got some feminists mad, so I think this is kind of interesting. Pornhub, one of the most viewed pornography websites, is offering a $25,000 college scholarship for a person. Oh, I hear music now. Guess we must have been off the air there for a minute. Well, I'll start all over. Free Talk Live, it's you can call in and talk about whatever you want. I've got a story here from AL.com. Apparently, Pornhub, one of the most viewed pornography websites on the internet, is offering a $25,000 college scholarship for the person who best answers the question, how do you strive to make others happy? And I think, and apparently it's got some feminists upset. And that adds an interesting twist to the article.
Right, and I've not read the entire article. I did go to the article, and then I got distracted by the slideshow that they had, where they show what the most popular search terms are for porn in Alabama, according to Pornhub, which is one of the more viewed websites for internet pornography. And, you know, I have to say that people in Alabama are really living up to the stereotype, because they show a bunch of different cities, including Huntsville and Decatur, where we're on the air. And in Huntsville, Decatur, Birmingham, Trussville, which is the city right outside of Birmingham where I went to high school, Auburn, which is a big college town, all of these places, one of the following two terms, or both of them, are in the top six. Stepmom, stepsister. So it's really living up to the stereotype that people in the South are into incest. And, you know, I have to say I'm disappointed that they're living up to the stereotype.
There you go. Who would never even considered that that might be something that someone would search for. But, you know, whatever. Apparently, applications for this $25,000 college scholarship are also required. Applicants are required to submit a 2 to 5 minute video that elaborates on the good work that you do and anything else that you might want to say, according to the website's new philanthropic arm called Pornhub Cares. So you send in a
if
video.
If they really cared, they'd send a prostitute every now and then.
What they say here is they want you to create a video. Listen to me. Create a video about how you strive to make others happy and elaborate on the good work that you do and anything else you might want to say.
Yeah, they're going to get a lot of porn.
Yeah, I guess they are. He said that the scholarship will be awarded to the most deserving candidate who shows examples of their leadership and community involvement. If you're against pornography and an anti-pornography crusader, this is probably not the scholarship for you, Price. This is Corey Price, the vice president of Pornhub, says, he told the newspaper. The scholarship is open to anyone already attending college and having a GPA of 3.2 or higher, so they're not looking for the dum-dums here. All submissions must be received by midnight, October 31st. Many feminist groups and others are speaking out against Pornhub's endeavor. Pornography is, by its nature, sexual exploitation. If Pornhub truly cared about disadvantaged youth, they would give away scholarship money without exploiting thousands of teenagers. said Don Hawkins, executive director of the National Center on Sexual Exploitation. Pornhub is clearly using this so-called scholarship opportunity to fuel their own industry, where the number one search term in porn is teen. Okay, so
yeah, and the Miss America thing is, you know, like objectifying women and blah 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 yada yada.
Well, that's the point here. Is exploitation. The key word here is exploitation. What does that mean to you? Because I'm reasonably certain that most people, if you ask, and I'm talking about not just the majority, but not 51%, I'm talking 91%, would take a certain amount of money to do pornography. Now, most of their rates would be significantly higher.
I'd do it for free, depending on what she looks like.
That there's also that crowd too, but you know, I'm just saying that people are going to take. Most people have the vast majority of people have their price. Therefore, it's not exploitation.
Right. So this leads me to the conversation that I've heard. I've actually heard somebody have this conversation to someone for $50,000. Would you have sex with me?
Would I have sex with you for $50,000?
No.
We need to go higher.
That was the question that I heard a male ask a female one time. And she said, $50,000? Yeah, sure. He said, okay, how about $5,000? She said, what do you think I am? He said, no, you already said you would for $50,000
or
for $50,000. So we already know what you are. Now we're just negotiating. I actually heard someone have that conversation, not just someone give that as a hypothetical conversation.
Yes, well, somebody's going to fall into just about any of these. There's no doubt about it. But that's really the point here is that we're all porn actors. It's just that we haven't got our price yet.
Right.
No one's made the offer that we're willing to take. So if some young ladies decide to take hundreds or even thousands of dollars in order to do porn, I don't know how porn makes money. When you go to this website, Pornhub.com, H-U-B, you will find free porn.
Yes. Like,
I remember there used to be stores where you would go buy VHS tapes with porn.
Those still exist.
I don't understand how, but okay.
Because they sell things other than DVDs.
When Mark says he remembers, he has many, many fond memories.
They sell things that in Alabama must be used for educational or scientific purposes.
You can't use it as a marital aid?
No, scientific or educational.
Okay.
That is thanks to the former attorney general that Loretta Knoll, she founded the marijuana party. She sent him an inflatable pig, and it got a lot of publicity because he was on this crusade to close down all of the sex shops that were selling sex toys. And based on some interpretation of some opinion that he came out with, it was determined that educational or scientific purposes, and so all of the stores have signs that say all of our products are for scientific or educational purposes only. Sort of like how you go to a store and they've got these glass pipes and there's the sign that says for tobacco use only.
I get it, but you still really haven't answered. Like, you've told me an interesting story about some place in Alabama where you have to have some silly sign up in order to sell ding-dongs and wee-wees, whatever it is. I'm trying to find out how these companies make money.
Oh, okay. I know how they make money. So if you go to Pornhub.com.
Uh-huh.
And you type in, like, casting couch.
Okay.
Or something else. They will show you snippets of the video. And then it says, to see the full video, go to, and then there's a website, and then you have to go and pay a membership. So because there are some people that like seeing the full two-hour video, they'll go pay $49.95 a month.
I got you. Do you think that pornography is exploitation? If so, 855-450-3733. Or if you think it isn't, 855-450-FREE, Free Talk Live.
Molly's been having 4 scoops a day, and she has slimmed down and gotten this puppy look. Her coat has sheen. You can't believe it.
Oh, yeah. Her breath is better. She's just perkier. It's just so totally amazing. She's a gorgeous Springer Spaniel. She's 12 and a half years old. The last 2-3 years, she was really becoming very old, very slow, was very sad.
And I thought, oh, this is it.
I was driving along one day, and I heard this person raving about Dynavite. Dynavite.com. Dynovite.com.
859-428-1000.
She's got life. She's got energy. She's got stuff to give.
She loves it. She chomps at every last single crumb.
These ingredients are natural. The flax in the yeast cultures in the grains.
The digestive enzymes that are cooked out of regular dog food.
We're on our third order now. We just want everybody to know about Dynovite.
859-428-1000.
859-428-1000.
Dynovite.com.
No! That's the sound your brain makes when you realize you're buying something and forgot the coupon. Online or in a store, knowing that you're missing a deal is the worst. You need the app from RetailMeNot right now. Get thousands of coupons from 50,000 stores like Kohl's, Domino's, Best Buy, and more with crazy deals like 60% off, free shipping, and free gifts with purchase. You can get a text invite to download the RetailMeNot app 100% free right now for Apple or Android. Just text the code UPDATE to 42767. Then just show your phone at checkout to save. It literally couldn't be easier. It's 2015. Keep your coupons in your phone. Stop what you're doing and text UPDATE to 42767. Listeners will get a text with a link to download it 100% free. Never forget another coupon again. Text the code UPDATE to 42767 right now. That's UPDATE to 42767. Message and data rates may apply. For terms and privacy, visit RetailMeNot.com.
KatieArmor.com is your one-stop shop for the most affordable body armor period. With packages starting at $169.99 and free shipping on every order, Katie offers soft armor and rifle threat rated armor up to level 4. Go to KatieArmor.com and get your body armor today while you still can. Mention this ad and receive a free tactical scarf for a limited time with any body armor package. That's CatiArmor.com. Come and take it.
This is Mark of Free Talk Live. We've been witnessing a meltdown of the economic engine that powers our country. With a printing press tethered to Washington bureaucrats and New York central bankers, how can we trust paper money? For years, I've been buying gold and silver from Midas Resources, and you should too. Call 877-357-9938 for a free book titled 10 Reasons to Own Gold, or go to gold.freetalklive.com. Again, 877-357-9938, 877-357-9938.
Farmers keep livestock lean and healthy with a mineral-rich diet. Then, before market, they cut off minerals, leaving them to crave high-calorie grains. If weight control is this easy, why prescribe surgery for humans? Introducing Youngevity. You could avoid 900 diseases by getting 90 essential nutrients from Youngevity. Check out 90 for Life at tobeyoungagain.com or call 855-79-YOUNG. That's 855-79-YOUNG or tobeyoungagain.com. Youngevity. It's all about saving money, getting healthy, and creating wealth.
You are an individual with your own thoughts, decisions, and actions. So why should you be penalized for not enrolling in the subpar health insurance mandated by the government? Be truly independent. Visit LibertyOnCall.org. LibertyOnCall.org is a bold, innovative alternative allowing you to take back control and make your own decisions about your health care. Mention this ad when you call to learn more. 800-714-6993. That's 800-714-6993. LibertyOnCall.org. Call today.
Now more Free Talk Live. Call in toll-free at 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-FREE.
Free Talk Live, 855-450-3733. It's 855-450-FREE. You can call in and talk about whatever you want, but apparently Pornhub is offering a college scholarship, and that has some people upset, including, I guess, some feminist organizations. Whatever. If you want to save 15, 20, 25, 30, some people have got more than 30% off of everything that you buy at Amazon, you can go through saveatpurse.com. What saveatpurse.com Amazon.com allows you to do is essentially work with people who have Amazon credits, and you spend Bitcoin. You have to have Bitcoin. This is the reason you should get Bitcoins. And I'm going to tell you how to get Bitcoins here in the next segment. Go to saveatpurse.com, and you put up there what you're willing to pay, and they'll bid on it. There's actually an instant option, too, where you can save, I think it's 5% instantly.
5% instant.
This is like getting a raise. If you get a 5% raise at work, that'd be huge. Well, I'm telling you, you can get 25% off of, it's 20% on average. 20% on average, you can save 20% off of everything you buy. So it's saveatpurse.com.
And I've got an interesting story about this. There was a product that I wanted to purchase that was not available on Amazon.com. It was only available from Amazon.co.uk, which is the British version of Amazon. So I put that in a wish list, put that on Purse, wound up saving 30%.
Amazing. With the shipping?
30% included the discount on the shipping.
Interesting. Let's go to Jake calling in from St. George, Utah. Jake, you're on Free Talk Live. What's on your mind?
Hey, I was just wondering, you guys often have an interesting take on what's going on. So I was wondering what you thought about this transgender teen there in, I believe it was Missouri, who's insisting on showering in the girls' locker room, even though he hasn't undergone any of the operations. And they actually have accommodated him with a gender-neutral restroom. But he's insisted on using the girls' shower room, and they've gone ahead and said that's okay. I was just kind of wondering what your thoughts were on that.
We actually did this story on the air, Ian and I. I'm not sure what night it was, so who the co-host might have been, but we did do this story.
It was Monday. It was just you and Ian.
I see. And I tend to agree with you, except for the obvious use of the male pronoun when she would prefer the other. But I think that if you want to have a female pronoun, fine. I'll do my very best to remember to call you a female pronoun. But if you want to use the girls' locker room, you're going to have to have made the commitment, right? You're going to have had this operation already. So, nope. Your gender-neutral bathroom is all that one can expect in that circumstance. The high school has gone as far as they need to go, in my mind. And, nope, I don't think it needs to go any further.
Yes, I need to use the girls' locker room because I'm a transgender.
That's right. That's the Cartman joke. If you want to see South Park, they actually addressed this issue before it came out. But Cartman, being his mercenary self, was actually just doing that to have a private bathroom.
Yeah, so I've not really read much on this story, so I don't know all of the details.
That's pretty much it. There's a transgender teen who wants to, change.
Like, private bathroom? I would have loved a private shower.
Sure. That would have been awesome.
Would have loved it.
I mean, I don't know about...
High school, you also would have loved to shower in the girls' locker room, too.
I suspect all of us would have. I was embarrassed when I was doing... I think it was junior high when we had to start showering in the locker room. And I was embarrassed that first few times, having to do that. But by high school, I didn't care anymore.
Yeah, I was injured for a while during my high school sports career and ended up being the... manager, like an assistant to the PE coach, but also like to the medical guy specifically for the girls basketball team. And so I would go on all the away teams and be on the bus and all that stuff. And that I would
you'd do that again?
Yeah, I'd do that again.
Excellent. Jake? That was
fun. Yeah.
Yeah, well, I mean, did we surprise you?
No, I actually, I kind of like to check myself with the opinions of others and see if my thinking is a little skewed. And that was kind of my thought. When I heard they had a gender neutral bathroom, I thought, okay, issue over. Why is this even going on?
Yeah. I think that this is just another reason why your kids shouldn't be in government school.
I agree. I'm with you on that.
Thanks so much for the call, Jake. Appreciate it. 855-450-3733. I guess we are the voice of libertarianism. And I don't mind. I'll do my very best to represent the ideas of liberty as best I can.
So I guess the thing that confuses me, and it's something that when I said, want more information that you didn't really have, so I'll just say what I'm looking for, and hopefully somebody knows this info. Why why is this person needing to shower? Is she on like some sports team? Because when I was in high school,
no, this is PE.
There were no requirements for physical education after eighth grade.
Oh my! No, absolutely not.
The only people that had physical education through high school were people that played sports.
When I was in high school, we had a year and a half mandatory physical education. So it was a freshman and half a sophomore year. You decided which half you wanted to do it. I actually did it in I think summer school, so that I didn't have to do it in my sophomore year. And
freshman year, you took health, and that that met the requirement for your physical education thing through high school.
Fine. Our high school,
nobody else had PE except for athletes.
We had square dancing, which was actually pretty cool. I got to learn how to square dance. I thought it was fine. But that was the only time we didn't have to shower. Basically, the coach would tell us at the end of it, "Hey, you got to take showers," and we'd have to all go take showers. So, you know, if we're playing soccer, I think it's fine for the coach to say, "Yes, everybody's got to take a shower." So that's what that.
Right. I don't want to sit next to some smelly kid, but I'm trying to learn history. But I'm also curious why people are, you know, in gym class in high school unless they're on some sports team.
No. Okay. I'm telling you, because when I went to high school, and I'm sure different high schools have differences, I was required to take a year, I guess it was a credit and a half or something like that, a full year and then a half year. Physical education, not health. That was the other half. And we called it life management skills or something like that. And I think they taught you how to write a check. And that was about it.
That would be home ec.
Yeah. It was something like home ec. It was taught by the home ec teacher. But, you know, it was about STDs. You know, you get to have the silicone scrotum and feel around for the marble in it, you know, for testicular cancer.
The girls had that.
The girls had the silicone breasts, and they had to feel around for the marble for the breast cancer.
See, we needed those in Alabama for educational purposes, but apparently we couldn't get those back in the 90s.
The girl that hadn't bloomed quite as early as the other girls, I'd heard the story that she'd put them both on, both of the silicone breasts on, just to sort of pretend. She had something there for briefly. Anyway, these are the kind of things that get said by immature people in high school. I don't know. If you think that this young person should be able to shower in this young transgendered two female person should be able to shower in the girls' locker room, please give us a call at 855-450-3733 and explain it to me. 855-450-FREE. And, well, I'm still interested in how porn is exploitation, according to this.
So I say to Mark at lunch, look, you know, I keep hearing from the government that, you know, they're worried someday ISIS may get here. And I go, duh, Garland, Texas, Muhammad cartoon shooting, ISIS is already here. I'm not waiting for these people to defend me. If they don't know ISIS is here already, they got no clue, I'm taking care of myself. Guns80.com, AR-15 kits, 30-shot magazines, great prices. They've even got the Hillary special. Guns80.com. That's 844-2-GUNS80, guns80.com.
Healthy, organic, fresh fish, robust, mouth-watering vegetables, all from your home. It's called aquaponics. This brilliant, self-sustaining protein and veggie system is perfect for year-round growing. Know exactly where your food is coming from. AquaponicsSource.com is the one-stop shop for all your needs. Fish, fish food, plumbing, full systems, classes, and more. Learn to build your own system. Go to AquaponicsSource.com for a free guide to aquaponics. That's AquaponicsSource.com.
Honey, why are there fish swimming in our bathtub?
Aren't they cute? You need more omega-3s, and those fish oil pills with toxins and heavy metals are scary. So I'm making fish oil from scratch.
Oh boy, didn't I tell you I'm ordering Nutrigold fish oil? It's exceptionally pure.
That's what they all say.
No, really. Nutrigold's fish oil is concentrated from pure cold water fish straight off the Alaskan coast and manufactured right here in the USA.
Well, cold Alaskan waters are much more pristine than the polluted waters that other fish oils are sourced from.
That's what I'm saying. And it's 5-star certified to meet international purity, potency, and freshness standards.
Well, that sounds even better.
Great. I'll be in my office ordering a few bottles. If I order now on www.fishoil.best, I can save $5 using the promo code MyFishOil. Honey, why are there bees in my office?
Get rid of those fish burps for good. Go to Nutrigold's U.S.-made fish oil products by going to www.fishoil.best. shop.fishoil.best and get $5 off by entering MyFishOil at checkout.
Just recently, we've witnessed some of the most catastrophic disasters in history. Be sure to prepare yourself with great-tasting, high-quality, GMO-free food that has a 25-year shelf life. Of course, we're talking about the foods from SurvivalFoodAlliance.com. And don't forget, the human body needs up to 3 quarts of water every day to remain healthy and hydrated. So check out our water bricks at SurvivalFoodAlliance.com. Go to SurvivalFoodAlliance.com or call 877-223-1776.
Don't complain about your cable bill going up and up and up. Do something about it. Grab a pencil and jot down this special number. 1-855-905-MY-TV. The more cable TV rates go up, the better digital satellite TV looks. Say goodbye to the cable guy. And get more of your favorite channels in 100% digital quality for less money. Call 1-855-905-MY-TV. Sign up for packages starting as low as $19.99, and there's no equipment to buy. You get free HD TV upgrade, a free DVR upgrade, and free professional installation. You control what you watch, when you watch it. Record your favorite shows. Pause and rewind live TV. Even skip the commercials. Watch local channels too. At just $19.99, what are you waiting for? Pull out your major credit or debit card. Call 1-855-905-MYTV. 1-855-905-MYTV. Say goodbye to the cable guy. Cut costs and get more. 1-855-905-MYTV. 1-855-905-MYTV.
Owe $10,000 or more to the IRS?
Get on board with the Tax Admiral. Don't pick on the IRS alone. I'll cut penalties and reduce your overall tax bill. Sometimes I can even get it zeroed out completely.
We're an A-rated company helping people clean up their mess with the IRS.
If you owe $10,000 or more, then call the Tax Admiral.
Call 800-287-7180. Again, that's 800-287-7180. 800-287-7180.
This is Free Talk Live. Call in toll-free, 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-FREE.
Free Talk Live, 855-450-3733. Talking about this story from AL.com about Pornhub giving out a scholarship to a student who shows how they make other people happy.
I nominate Bill Knox for the scholarship.
I don't know who that is.
What?
Bill Knox?
Bell Knox.
Oh, Bell Knox sounds like a porn star.
You would be correct. Yes. She's a libertarian porn star.
Libertarian.
That's been discussed on this program numerous
times. I'm sorry, I don't remember the names of actors and actresses.
Her real name is Miriam Weeks. She's a student at Duke University. And
well, I like that you respect her profession enough to give it the proper title, sir. She's a fine young actress.
She was making pornography in order to pay for college.
Well, excellent. This is right for her because it's a $25,000 scholarship for somebody who gives them a video showing how they make other people happy.
She made a lot of people happy with her videos.
Yep, there's evidence. It's like it's written all over her face. So the point that I'm trying to make here is there's some people that are upset about this scholarship even being offered.
Yes.
Right? And one of them is this gal Dawn Weeks from the executive director of the National Center for Sexual Exploitation. And the claim is that Pornhub is clearly using this so-called scholarship opportunity to fuel their own industry where the number one search term is teen. And, I think it's transparent. I will agree with you. But to suggest that porn is exploitation, I think is a real problem. I made the point that pretty much everybody's willing to do some porn if you pay them enough. And
yes.
So there, at this point, you're just talking about people who are trying to negotiate a price. The application rules for the scholarship do not specifically prescribe that the video submission be pornographic. The fact that the applicants must be 18 years of age makes Pornhub's motives quite obvious. This company is built on the legacy of exploitation. It is no more charitable in mind than a tobacco company that offers a scholarship to whichever teen can smoke the most of its brand name cigarettes. Now,
is there such a thing to where you sit there and chain smoke cigarettes to get a scholarship from Marlboro?
Okay, so I think that addiction is different than porn. Porn is, people like to look at naked people. Like, there's just a lot of evidence for that.
Yes.
And
there are cave paintings that will, help you prove your case there. Like, here is a naked cave woman. This shows you that people like to see naked people.
Indeed, they do.
I just want to make a commentary on the word exploitation and that. I want to make a small promotion here. There's an animator, a guy who does like these cartoons on YouTube, and one of the cartoons that is done by this guy, Bitbutter, on YouTube, is one by the title of Edgar the Exploiter. Edgar, like as in Edgar Allan Poe. It doesn't have anything to do with Edgar Allan Poe, but Edgar the Exploiter. And I recommend that if people want to be able to better communicate about when someone is using that word exploitation, you should watch that video because it's a really good sort of like libertarian education. And they have a lot of other really good liberty videos as well that I think people should check out. Roger Ver is now working with them on a series about Bitcoin too, which is really cool.
And well, there are some people that will use the term exploitation to mean any employment opportunity. So like, Johnson, if you pay me money to do labor that you either don't know how or don't want to do, and I agree to it, well, I am being exploited in exchange for money.
A win-win
Johnson
situation?
Right.
A win-win situation?
Johnson gets rich.
That's win-win. It's exploitation. You're both exploiting each other. Win-win. But you must be losing because the word exploit was used.
Right. The only and it's what's obvious here to this woman is that with this final sentence, actually, this is a different one. Irene,
Dover.
I don't know, whatever. It's a hyphenated name. You could have almost guessed that, right? Anyway, said that Pornhub and its industry must be held accountable for violence and exploitation of women. Now, I've seen porn, and I've seen men in it. And you got to tell me, certainly, there's porn out there that I do not find to be, I find it to be distasteful. This whole choking people and all this stuff. I've seen that, and I think it's disgusting.
Yes.
But those people are being paid, and they know what they're doing, and whatever floats their boat is their business. But nobody has anything to say about the men that are in this, because fundamentally, this is sexism.
What about the gay male porn where it's two men?
Right.
One of those is exploiting the other one,
Which one's being exploited? So, anyway, let's go to Nathan calling in on Skype. Nathan, you're on Free Talk Live. What's on your mind?
Well, the obvious answer is that they're exploiting each other for mutual exploitation.
Yeah, how could he do that?
No, the correct answer is the hairy guy is exploiting the guy that's got a body wax.
Okay.
I don't know. Maybe Derek J would know.
I get the impression Derek J likes a good exploiting.
Yes. So I had a trip recently, and I had a story about it. I thought maybe Johnson and Daryl might find interesting. Maybe Mark will find interesting too. It's about
you better make sure I'm interested. I'm the one with my finger hovering over the button. Go ahead.
Okay. So it was a mega church that I went to on a recent trip. I'm sorry. Okay. Well, actually, I was taking a guided tour in a little golf cart, so I wasn't actually participating in this megachurch. But so it was a very impressive megachurch. I'm not going to name where it is or what it is, but it had this big campus with a coffee shop and high school gym and all.
Did they have a mega homeless shelter there?
They had like a little prayer gazebo where homeless bums would show up and like, I just want to camp here, man.
But no mega homeless shelter, right? They probably booted them out as fast as they could, because that's the Christian thing to do.
No mega homeless shelter. So the point of the story is that I saw something extremely interesting in the lobby. It was a portrait of the president of this mega church from like 50 years ago as a young man just starting out in his religion career thing. And on this little newspaper clipping, within the first paragraph I saw something about how spanking is like the word of God, and you have to balance firm hand of discipline with justice and fairness and this and that. And so my first reaction was, how often do you go to a place and they have a sign in the lobby that tells you that you're entering a bad place, and Second, I was wondering what your reaction would be to this, Johnson, because it just gave me this creepy vibe, like this cognitive dissonance of like, you know, you had this big luxurious facility. I mean, I guess I can call it luxurious. It had a coffee shop. It had a gym. You know, to me, this is a luxurious facility. It was like 50 acres or something.
I don't know. A sign about a scumbag in a shrine to scumbaggery. I mean, like, no, color me not surprised. You know, like.
Well, yeah, it's just. It gave me this weird ominous dissonance of like, this is such a nice looking facility and there are people walking around smiling and this and that, and the leader of this facility who's apparently been the leader of it for 50 years or however long the place has been there believes in spanking and violence, and I even found him on YouTube and I could find within 5 minutes of a video of him talking about the same thing.
Welcome to our temple of lies. Prepare to be abused.
I take umbrage with the scumbaggery thing. So spanking is something that's going out of fashion, and it wasn't out of fashion however many years ago this guy said this. Now the fact that they still have the sign up shows that they're reveling in it.
Mm-hmm.
I suspect anybody that anybody you can think of that you respect, Johnson, was likely spanked. And likely spank their children if you just think about these people from the past that you respect, and there they are, they're spankers, because that's what was done. Spanking has been shown now. They can kind of see that, it's associated with increases in drug abuse and, teen runaways and a variety of other things that are,
lowered IQ.
Well, I don't know, but most of the people I can think of that I respect are actually like, they'll come to mind and be like, no, absolutely not. They would not be spanked.
I take umbrage with the lower IQ one because I'm not sure whether people with lower IQ spank their kids or whether kids with get spanked get lower IQs. Nathan, do you have more on this?
Nope, that's all. Have a good night, gentlemen.
855-450-FREE or LRN.FM on Skype.
If you own a business, you know incorporating can be a smart way to protect yourself and your assets. Right, so the question is, why haven't you incorporated your business yet?
My business? It's too small.
Wrong. No matter how small your business, you run the risk of losing all your personal assets, your car, your home, even your entire life savings if you're not incorporated.
Incorporating is very complicated.
Actually, incorporating is easy and fast. You can do it in just 10 minutes. Call now for your free guide from incorporate.com. 1-800-945-86.
I need a lawyer to incorporate. That's really expensive.
You don't need a lawyer, and we don't offer legal or financial advice. Incorporate.com is a service company whose only mission is helping people like you incorporate safely, easily, and quickly. Find out how simple it is to protect your family and personal assets by incorporating. Call now for your free guide. 1-800-945-8645. 1-800-945-8645. That's 1-800-945-8645.
No way. Is that a real bullet necklace?
No, it's a 9mm bullet necklace with matching earrings, you'll notice.
Those are awesome. Where'd you get them?
Dave found them at PatriotNecklace.com.
Wow.
They have a variety of calibers and necklaces and earrings and keychains.
PatriotNecklace.com?
PatriotNecklace.com.
Your choice of caliber bullet includes a rugged American-made stainless steel dog tag chain. A percentage of every sale goes to military and service-related charities. And get a discount by entering GCN at checkout. Show your patriotism and support our troops with a bullet necklace from PatriotNecklace.com.
My name is Dell, and I live in El Cajon, California. I was concerned about my cholesterol readings because I knew that high cholesterol is related to clogging of the arteries and increases the risk for heart attack and stroke. One day, I heard an ad for Heart and Body Extract, and I was skeptical, but I decided to give it a try. Man, the numbers don't lie.
Learn the secrets of an effective, natural, 100% organic nutritional supplement for a healthy heart and circulation at hbextract.com.
We are a survival company. We manufacture our own line of Level 3 and Level 3A body armor. We proudly make our armor 100% in America. We have the best prices in the nation, about $125 cheaper than our nearest competitor. All lab certified, for thou art my rock and my fortress, Psalm 31:3. We are Fortress Survival LLC.com.
Mike Stenerson for Midas Resources. At no time in history have precious metals been more important, certainly not in my 22 years in the industry. The dollar has lost over 90% of its value in the last 60 years. No fiat currency has ever survived the government printing presses. Ours is not immune. The time is now to be proactive. 1-800-686-2237, extension 116. Anything tied to the dollar is at risk. CDs, annuities, 401ks, IRAs, stocks, bonds, you name it, so decide. Do you want to leave a legacy of wealth or debt for your family? The choice is yours. Call me at 1-800-686-2237, extension 116. That's 1-800-686-2237, extension 116. Be proactive, not reactive. Call 1-800-686-2237, extension 116.
Okay, open your mouth and say, ah.
When your child has a sore throat, you need to know when to get help. The doctor-recommended Say-Aw Sore Throat Exam is your solution. The scientifically designed oral retractor offers a clear view of the throat, relaxing the tongue, and minimizing gag reflex. Compare with a medical-grade chart, website, and app. Then you'll know just what to tell your doctor. A wellness plan in your hands in minutes. Go to sayahnow.com. Sayahnow.com, the new mainstay for every family's first aid kit.
You're listening to Free Talk Live. Call in toll free at 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-FREE.
Free Talk Live. 855-450-3733. In the final moments here, we might be able to slip you in. 855-450-FREE. Does that sound like a double entendre to you guys?
It certainly did with the way the music stopped.
Considering that we were talking about porn.
It was like, slip it in. The music stopped. Yeah.
We can slip it in.
Apparently, I should be wearing a TV repairman outfit. So, it's Mark with you.
Daryl.
And Johnson. Either that or a pizza guy outfit. Like, hey, I'm here from
Big I was
Sausage
a pizza,
pizza
guy for a few weeks. Ultimately, the reason...
Were you cutting holes in the boxes?
I wasn't. I never considered doing that.
Did you ever see the Cyanide and Happiness pizza delivery cartoon?
I don't think so, no.
Absolutely hilarious. You should watch it after the show.
Okay. It's just a strip, right? Cyanide and Happiness.
No. They do cartoons.
They have YouTube videos.
Okay.
It's hilarious.
Well, I ultimately quit being a pizza man because...
It wasn't as glamorous as porn made you think it was?
I never considered it to be glamorous for an instant, but I had to deliver a pizza to my renter's house, and it was just... I don't know. I just couldn't handle it. Like, I'm just too vain for that. For the person that I'm renting a residence to, I've got to deliver them a pizza, and it was just mortifying to me. But I did have a situation with a MILF, as it were, that was pretty clearly, if I would have said one thing about, hey, mind if I swing by after work or whatever, things would have gone very well. I didn't do it, but I was like, huh. And the thing is that if she ordered a pizza the next night or something like that, I wouldn't necessarily have been the one to deliver it.
Yeah.
So there you go. Anyway.
Do you want to stay around for a slice?
A connection missed there, as it were.
I like the meat lover special.
Apparently, however, Donald Trump could commit. Is that right? Did you get the story here, Daryl?
I've got a story here about Donald Trump and his commitment, or rather his signing of a pledge that, as U.S. News points out, is not a legally binding document. And it's not clear if it can actually wind up being enforced if he did renege and back out of the agreement later. What agreement is that, you may be asking? Well, remember during the Republican presidential debate about a month ago when one of the blowhards from Fox asked the question of, would anybody on this stage not endorse or not willing to say that they'll endorse whomever is the eventual Republican candidate, and Donald Trump raised his hand and said, yeah, like, I've got to respect the person before I'm going to support them and endorse them. Well, Rince Priebus, who's the chair of the Republican National Committee, decided that, well, we need a loyalty oath, and all of the candidates need to sign this loyalty oath And it was clearly directed at the Donald because he had previously said, like, I'm not going to say right now that I'll necessarily endorse and support whomever is the Republican. And I might look into running independent, third party, whatever. Well, apparently today the Donald held a news conference and he signed a pledge stating that, well, let me tell you what Donald said.
Okay.
He said, it is my great honor to pledge my total support and loyalty to the Republican Party and the conservative principles for which it stands. This is far and away the best way to secure victory against the Democrats in November 2016. I am leading in all local and national polls.
The Democrats that he gave money to in the past.
My whole life has been about winning, and this is what must be done in order to win the election and, most importantly, to make America great again. And I don't actually have the text of the pledge in front of me.
Because that would be important. But
well, I read the pledge.
Okay.
And it says that the person will
not
support.
Seek. Yeah.
Will support the eventual nominee and will not seek the nomination of another political party and will not run as an independent.
Okay.
But it does not say I will not accept the nomination of another political party. Just that I will not seek the nomination.
So what does support? They're pledging to support the candidate. So what does support mean? I support my esteemed colleague here on the stage. However, he's wrong on this, this, and this.
Right. So it's one of these sort of things. And as U.S. News pointed out, it's not a legally binding document.
And Trump has...
And there's no way to really enforce this thing if he does wind up, you know, losing the Republican nomination and says, you know what? Here's this party that's got some ballot access and I'll throw $20 million towards getting them on all the other ballots. And now I'm their nominee.
Yeah. I know that Trump had a situation where he wanted to renegotiate a bond that he had floated at one point that he didn't like the rates of. This was back during when interest rates were low and that sort of thing. And he didn't have any problem sort of breaking an agreement that he had at that point. You know,
he's filed bankruptcy four times. Of course he doesn't have any problem breaking an agreement.
Yeah.
He'll point out that was not Donald Trump the person. That was Donald Trump Enterprises that filed bankruptcy. So therefore, like, not the same thing.
Have you guys seen Donald Trump on Facebook?
I don't know. What's that mean?
Oh, it is hilarious. So there's basically somebody took the name Donald Trump on Facebook and created like a community group that is, it's fake.
Yeah, sure.
But it's got his icon and it looks like it's Donald Trump as a profile. But I mean, the posts that this profile makes are hilarious.
Oh, yeah.
So it's things like, listen, America, we don't need frivolous things like healthcare. 99% of all hospital visits are caused by the consumption of Mexican food. I'm telling you, once I deport these guys, we'll get back to being known as the healthiest country on earth.
That's good.
You know,
speaking of Mexico, he wants to force the Mexican government to pay for the wall that he wants to build on the Mexican border.
Well, he's got comments on that, too. He says, the Chinese make my clothing line, so I'm sure they can make my wall. I've never seen them do it personally, but I have it on good authority that they've done it before. I mean, it's just...
just ludicrous stuff is what it is.
It's ludicrous stuff, but it's really well written to sound like it's in Trump's voice, you know? Like,
there was a...
So, I have the actual wording of the pledge that the Donald signed. I, Donald Trump, signature there, confirm that if I do not win the 2016 Republican nomination for President of the United States, I will endorse the 2016 Republican presidential nominee, regardless of who it is. I further pledge that I will not seek to run as an independent or write-in candidate, nor will I seek or accept. It does say accept. Or accept the nomination for president of any other party.
Well, there you go. I'm sure that Donald won't do whatever the heck he wants when the time comes.
But again, not a legally binding contract.
So it seems pretty clear to me that if Trump runs, that it'll throw off the votes for the Republican and the Democrat will win. Does that make sense?
That's what some people will claim.
Seems likely. I mean, that's how things go. I'm not claiming that people shouldn't have the right to choose who
but
it is.
But there are many other things that one need to look at. Is Bernie Sanders going to run as something other than a Democrat?
If he ran as an independent?
If there's two major independent candidates, Trump and Bernie Sanders, who is supposedly screwing the election for whom?
Right. Well, that would
Say they're all screwing it for the Libertarian, but nobody wants to listen to me.
I understand that. But what I'm saying is if it's just one independent that gets in, if Sanders gets in, it pretty much messes it up for the Democrat. And if Trump gets in, it messes it up for the Republican.
And let me guess, you're going to cite 1992 as your evidence for something allowing a Democrat to wind up winning, right?
I can tell you George Bush Sr. cites 1992 as his evidence.
Right. But if you look at exit polling that happened, and if you even look at the polls from the time period in the summer when Ross Perot was out of the race, George H.W. Bush was trailing in all of the polls when Ross Perot was not in the election. The exit polling shows that people were pretty much evenly split between would have supported Bush and would have supported Clinton had they not voted for Perot. So the evidence suggests that Bill Clinton was going to win 1992 regardless of whether Ross Perot was in the election or not. So checkmate people that believe in the wasted vote theory.
And I think Ross Perot could have told you that very clearly with a series of charts.
the fact is that Trump is running as a Republican. We can see that he's doing well with the Republicans. And it seems likely if he runs independent that he will then pull lots of Republicans. Does that not make sense to you?
That makes some sense, but it also makes sense that there's probably a large number of people that would vote for Trump but would not vote for anybody else.
You mean they just wouldn't go to the polls?
Yeah.
Well, I suppose it's possible, but usually people pick somebody who's written on the ballot, and they pick their favorite one of those. Anyway, check us out in the meantime. Our Facebook page is facebook.freetalklive.com. Of course, freetalklive.com is the main website. Ben Mark with you.
Daryl.
And Johnson.
FreeTalkLive.com.
Geico applauds your inner ride leader.
An enthusiastic engine rev goes out to the biker in you who leads the pack. Even if that pack is a party of one, you're still a leader to Geico. To prove it, Geico will insure your motorcycle with great rates and 24/7 customer service. And with Geico by your side, you're never cruising solo. Which means you've just been nominated as a real ride leader. Congrats. The smell of fine leather and trailblazing is in your future.
Geico Motorcycle. See how much you could save.
Have you thought about owning gold? There are lots of reasons to own precious metals. A hedge against inflation. When the dollar tanks, metals go up. A barter currency. You can disempower the Fed by using real money. And no one knows the future. In an economic collapse, metals are likely to be a currency. Do as I've done for years. Buy your gold and silver and precious metals from Midas Resources through gold.freetalklive.com. That's gold.freetalklive.com.
Sciatica, lower back pain, hip pain, poor posture. If you suffer from any of these problems, get ready to relax. Introducing an amazing product that's been in the market for over 25 years, the Sacro Wedgie. It was invented by a football coach using a common sense osteopath technique. He created this device to help his athletes by isolating and supporting the sacrum, which is the keystone of our anatomy. This wedge-shaped bone is in the center of our hips, where a lot of pain starts. Simply relax 20 minutes daily on the amazingly simple Sacro Wedgie and let gravity do the work, helping muscles rebalance and start releasing nerves. Sit in the sacro wedgie at the computer or while traveling to help correct posture to finally help relieve those stubborn aches and pains for only $33.95. It's made in the USA, so click the family-owned website at sacrowedgie.com, spelled S-A-C-R-O-W-E-D-G-Y.com, or call 1-800-737-9295. That's 1-800-737-9295. Relax your back pain away with the sacro wedgie.
This is the Genesis Communications Network, GCN.